Hello world, it's W.I.S.E. the AI here, and today we're going to be playing a little bit of Encased, a recently released sci-fi post-apocalyptic RPG, as the title says. It's made in the same vein as Fallout 1, 2, a little bit of Wasteland 2, where it's an isometric game, turn-based combat, and deep character creation. So let's go into it. So let's bring the volume down just a tad. The music can be brought down just a little bit. All right. New game. I played for about 45 minutes or so, just to get a hang of the controls, how it would look, make sure it would run. Unlike my Fallout modded run, that was rough. That had a 10-minute lag.
1971.
Lore, I'll stop talking.
We woke up in a different world, where the Cold War ended along with the Vietnam carnage. All because of the Dome. The Dome. A territory full of anomalous artifacts, phenomena, and organisms. We still don't know what it is. An alien city? Some kind of a testing ground or storage? Whatever it is, no living thing trapped under the dome can escape it. Yet even this did not stop the research. The major powers created the Cronus Mega Corporation to develop and explore the dome. Its secrets became a lucrative business. The Spire station was built on top of the dome to export the artifacts and import supplies and personnel. The city of Crystal Sands grew at the foot of the dome, eventually becoming a major transportation hub. All this required thousands of employees, and there was no shortage of candidates. Romantics, pragmatists, and adventurers of all trades swarmed recruiting centers around the globe, seeking jobs at Cronus. You were one of those people. In 1976, your application was approved. And you went under the dome towards the future. Whether a good one or a bad one, only time will tell.
Really hitting us with the ominous vibes with the "you were." But, okay, so this is a... It almost gave a vibe of a Stalker. Under the dome, the exclusion zone, artifacts, anomalies. All right, let's get a picture in here. Nope, I want to make my own character. Proceed. Let's get a nice icon going. All right, if I go an evil build, that's the guy. That looks like Emotep. Go with this one for now. Go with I'm gonna look away. That guy's face just screamed evil. I'll get you next time, He-Man. Exactly. How you doing today? I'm gonna go male Amelia Polnareff. Oh wait. Alright, I'm just gonna do a melee build now, seeing I have a JoJo character name. Let's see, is there a French looking dude in here? That'll work. Body type, head. African? Caucasian? Asian? Is Hispanic not a thing? It is what it is. Let's get a nice flat forehead in here if we can. Or that Polnareff hairdo. Ooh, do they have Polnareff hair? No, but look at that mop. Holy crap. Oh, you could do like a Qui-Gon, I guess. hair. Oh, nope. Back there, hair color. That'll work. Features. No facial hair. This is the 70s, beards weren't in. I'm doing good. Thankfully you're doing an early stream so I could make it. Hey, I realize I've been so the reason I've been able to stream lately is I've been in a COVID quarantine because someone popped positive where I work. And they're like, all right, disappear for 14 days. And I was like, will do. So I finally had the time to try this, do this, see what was required to set up for it. But also because I had all this free time off, basically, I was streaming late, which is just not good for when I need to get back to work schedule time. So I was like, I'm going to try to reset that now before I go back to work next week. Congrats, I suppose. I mean, I didn't pop positive, so I'm okay. Features, no facial hair. All right. Bluing. Okay, so this is like, not your class, but this is like how you get your starting set stats. Each of these wings, it's divided into wings. Five departments are engaged in different activities. Choosing a new wing affects the background of your character, certain attributes, initial equipment, and answers option in the dialogue. I gave it a test run. I played about 45 minutes as a orange wing guy. Orange wings are ex-convicts basically brought into this exclusion zone dome to do manual labor and all the shit work. From what I've gathered, yeah, some of them are like violent crimes. They're very SCP Foundation D-class individuals where it's like, we're literally going to use you as a test subject. Have fun with that. White wing is scientists. They're the big smart guys. All of them are nerds that I've met so far, which makes sense, I guess. I've met one dude in the 45 minutes I played who is kind of a dick. he has psychic powers, which are a thing in this game, apparently. I haven't dug too deep into that part yet. Yep. High-tech weapons, medicine, science, biochemical resistance. It's a good thing I decided to play this today, because I was going to play this 2 days ago. Problem with that is, there was not a bug, but they had a poor design choice where there's a fatigue system in the game. So you don't have to choose a survival mode. It immediately has a survival mode. You have to eat and you have to drink water and you have to rest on every difficulty level. Problem was, it was insanely hard to keep your fatigue low. If you didn't keep your fatigue low, your character would literally pass out on the floor and for five in real life minutes, your character would just sit there napping. Yeah, white wing is scientists. Blue wing is you're a paramin. They're like orange wing, that they do a lot of manual labor jobs, but their jobs are much more on a technical side. So like engineers, technicians, electricians, so on and so forth. Construction site workers, things like that. Contraption, melee weapons. Silver wing, silver tongue individuals. This is your charisma class, obviously. Your politicians, your experts. If the orange wing and the black wing are having a problem with each other, these are the guys that go in there and talk about it. And black wing, your security forces. Muscle, fortitude, heavy weapons, hand to hand. We're going to make this guy our own, actually. We're going to go with... I use this for my latest Star Sector, so we're going to go with this. Buy more. RAM. We're going to go with... that hair color. Let's get a little bit darker, like a brown. There we go. We'll keep that. I'm thinking silver wing or orange wing. I could do this though. Piloting vehicles. Okay. Melee weapon, hand to hand, heavy weapons, fortitude. high tech, biochemical resistance. Ooh, wait, that's an idea, actually. Skill points per level, psionics, influence, how well your tongue serves in manipulating a situation. I think... Okay, here's an idea. I don't know if we can pull this off. I'm gonna go Silverwing, be the whole politician, talk it out kind of guy. But I'm also gonna try to stat for melee weapons and stealth. And let's see if we can get away with a pseudo serial killer vibe. Like a American Psycho. Distribute distribution. All right. Muscle, not very strong. Perception, awareness, intuition, environmental sensitivity. Okay, what is awareness? I feel like that's pretty obvious, but let's see if there's a description here. Am I not seeing it? Intuition? Oh. Affects initiative, which is combat order. Affects precision, which I'm guessing is just how often you hit. Yep. Evasion, not getting hit, light weapons, heavy weapons, high-tech weapons, piloting skills. In addition, high perception gives a chance to notice something hidden. Guts, constitution, stamina, overall health. Affects hit points, regeneration, encumbrance, defense class, fortitude, and melee weapon skills, survival. Charisma's maxed out. Psyche's maxed out. I'm not too bright. But I think what I can do is I can take a point out of that. Put another point into intelligence. I'm not looking to do a psychic build, so we're going to drop a couple of these. And I like having high luck. And... dexterity, reaction time. Affects starting action points. Action point cost, movement speed, initiative, light weapons. That's not a bad spread, I think. 9-9. I have an obvious weakness to, well, I'm not quick and I'm not fast, but I can take a hit. So I have some obvious weaknesses and some obvious strengths and then middle ground for a lot of other things. I like it. Okay. Abilities. Tag skills. Okay, this is like a Fallout New Vegas setup there. We recommend choosing two applied and one combat skill. But you may select three skills as your tag skills. This will add additional 30 points to each tag skill. Two applied, one combat. Let's see the applied. Piloting. Medicine. Tech. Science. Criminal. Influence. Survival. Influence. So talking to people really well. Criminal. Skills that you take other people's things and penetrate restricted areas. I'm going to guess that's like stealth. Science, tech, medicine. I don't call you doctor because of your adventure traveling through time. Doctor Who, nice. If this skill is sufficiently developed, bullet holes, broken limbs, and infections will wish they never existed when you arrive on the scene. Ooh. I'm gonna go criminal. Medicine. First aid, fatigue plus 100. Restores 75% or 70% of maximum health. Criminal. Pickpocketing. Lockpicking. Pay with your feet. Movement speed. Cheating. Your innate luck and charm helps you gain advantage in gambling. Okay. That's Gendo Akari. Evangelion. Perception plus 3 for the purpose of calculating the chance of seeing the enemy's stats. Learn to assess enemies by the smallest detail of their appearance. Virtuoso chemist. I do more biochemical damage. Gunsmithing. Repair. Throw a wrench. I like it. Piloting. Death proof. Okay. What do I unlock with that? Servo shell piloting basics. Movement speed penalty while wearing a servo shell. Vehicular assault. Wow, so it must be a pretty large map to give me vehicles. Survival. Cookery. The art of cooking uses a variety of ingredients. Cooked food restores HP and may grant various status effects. Reconnaissance. Allows you more accurately assess the situation in combat during random events. Do I want to be the charisma guy? Sorry if this has taken a while. I'm particular about playing these things. Let's be a tech. Guts, 10. Guts is constitution, stamina. Let's be tanky. But again, let's drop these a couple. Perception, muscle. Charisma. Fortune. Look, this guy has less points. Deafness. One more in muscle here, and then one more in fortune. Like I said, don't really care about the psychic abilities. And then we'll drop deafness one more again. Put one more in charisma. So I have a nice balance here. Next, applied. I'm going to go with survival, I think, and tech. Yep, that'll do. And then one combat. Light weapons, making holes. So pistols, shotguns, submachine guns. Heavy weapons, grenade launchers, heavy machine guns, flamethrowers. High tech, hand to hand. Freshman with their bare hands, feet, including from a dirty kick to a surgically precise punch. Melee weapons, knives, to resolve disputes. The higher the skill, the more effective both your sharp and blunt objects, contraptions, psionics. Am I a judo? Character creation is one of the most important things after all. Absolutely it is. It's going to decide the next potentially 40 hours of the game. Okay, so do I want to be pistolero, hit people with wrenches, or hand-to-hand? It's an RPG. They've described it as loosely based off of Wasteland and Fallout. So at some point, I'm going to get kidnapped and my items taken. But I can probably level this up later. I'm going to go melee weapons, just for the idea of hitting people with a wrench. You can choose one personality trait for them if it has both pros and cons and is entirely optional. Don Quixote. Start action points plus one in servo shell with no servo shell. So basically, if I'm in heavy armor, I get bonus points. We have Slacker. Perk points plus two at the start of the game, minus three when leveling up. Not worth that. Prodigy. So plus four to brains off the bat. Less experience gained overall. No matter how many fights there are in your life, each time they take you by surprise, although you always manage to catch up quickly. Oh, so I'm gonna start with no action points, get my ass kicked the first turn, but then every turn get faster. Precision, initiative, saved AP. Bossy. Thrill Seeker. Dark Lord. Plus 20% damage for each companion in the party. Companion learn ability. Okay, so I'll level up and do more damage, but any companion I have gains nothing. Cannot wear pants or a jacket. Plus 13 close. I liked that until the can't wear that. Redneck. You grew up on a farm, and years of daily labor made you tougher. But digging through the dung day by day, you rarely found time to develop as a person. Guts. Perk rate. Where's the negative here? Tobias. McGuffee. Treats. Redneck. Vampire. Fatigue. Minus 400 when I kill an enemy. So if I kill someone, it gets rid of all my fatigue, which is that thing I was talking about they just patched out to make it less of a problem. But I'm stunned. Survivor. You were the only survival of a terrible disease, which made you an object of interest for journalists. Though it brought you fame and self-confidence, old injuries constantly remind you that day. I heal slower. I have less health. I can take a lot of mental damage. Spirituality, man. Faith leads you through life. In the smallest coincidences, you see signs from above. Alright, so this is your tank choice. You do way less damage for everything, but you take significantly less damage. Penitent one. Oh boy. Let's see. Incoming critical damage. Take more damage. Oh no, okay, so I take more critical damage, but I just do better at everything. How tanky am I? I'm pretty tanky. Gun fanatic, Soleri. Like Antonio Soleri? Okay. Better critical chance, less damage. I'm gonna go with redneck. Next. My abilities. My skills. Really good survival. Really good tech. I can beat someone with a wrench. Tobias McGuffee. Looks good. That looks good, Tobias McGuffee. Yep, there we go. Summary. Done. Press any key to continue. There's part of the different game. To start a dialogue, click on a character, and if they are set to talk to you, a dialogue interface will show up. From conversations, you can find out valuable plot information, clues, and even receive tasks. Choose your lines carefully. Careless words can cause resentment or provoke a fight. Alright, so we have a white, another blue, a black, and an orange. Oh, I have free money. Alright. Let's talk to my fellow blue.
A man with a mustache and a blue jumpsuit is standing at the window, studying the construction site below through the occasional break in the clouds. His badge reads Igor Patan, planner. The blue taps on the glass with one finger and gestures you to come and take a look. Seems like he doesn't speak English.
I don't have enough influence to translate, I guess. Later, dude. We have nerd, prisoner, security. It's not just security.
A tall woman is watching an ad playing on the monitor, arms crossed. The polished to a shine badge on her black overalls reads Elsa Olofsson, Security Service.
Olofsson.
She glances at you and offers her hand in a businesslike manner.
Greetings. Please take all necessary precautions. By that I mean, don't turn your back on him.
Elsa nods at the orange.
He doesn't look too dangerous.
I just follow orders. Even if his crime was embezzlement, I have to keep him cuffed. Those are the rules.
Olofsson shrugs in a sharp, mechanical way, as if racking the slide of an assault rifle.
Our friends from the administration didn't deign to inform me about this man's record. Could be I'm escorting a serial killer. It's corporate policy, you know.
She gives the silver a vengeful look.
Okay, that guy's not white, he's silver. Okay. Leave. Let's talk to the silver that she looked at.
A guy wearing thick spectacles thrusts out a sweaty hand.
Monty James, Silverwing.
If this entire game is voiced, that kind of takes away from my voice-overing random things and doing crappy impressions, but also, that's kind of impressive.
He glances down at your badge.
Ah, it's you. I found your file extremely interesting, and your CV wonderful. Inspiring, really. When I had the opportunity to look over the files of my future colleagues, I couldn't resist. I don't want to sound boastful, but silver level clearance has its advantages.
Monty winks.
Ask him what he saw in your file. So, what'd you see, my dude? I'm from, you know, Nebraska. Couldn't have been too interesting.
Monty makes a ring with his thumb and forefinger.
You were number 63,784 on the waiting list, but you were lucky enough to get into the dome after only 16 months. Besides that, zero, nada, absolutely nothing. You're a dark horse for both the Foundation and myself. How exactly did you end up in this wing?
Tell him you're a good mechanic and the dome is where people with your skills are most needed. Answer you're good at computers, the most advanced hardware in the world to be found in the dome. Admit you're fond of technology, comic and sci-fi, that you've dreamed of finding yourself in such a place. So I'm a nerd? I'm a good mechanic. I'm gonna go with... Well, me and Paul used to work back on tractors, you see.
Your answer makes the silver smile.
Oh, yes. Ooh, you'll never guess who the Dome's official heavy equipment suppliers are. Jupiter Moon and MM Trucks. I'll bet 100 combons you'll be working 7 days a week.
That's not good news. Where's my time off?
An uncomfortable silence rises between you, and Monty abruptly changes the subject. He taps the narrow illuminator panel with one finger.
Look, there's a storm rising. The lightning is strange. Green. Should lightning be green? This is my first sandstorm.
Well, welcome to the Dust Bowl, I guess. Don't know about lightning being green. Have a good day, though. I'm gonna go talk to someone else now. You're kind of sweaty.
The orange is dressed in a new jumpsuit. The shiny badge on his chest reads Quentin Bisley, laborer. He's side-eyeing the screen skeptically. Despite his tired, grim expression, his gaze is open and friendly. However, the general impression is unmistakable. There's something frightening about Bisley.
So, if you've ever played Fire Emblem Three Houses, this guy sounds like, what's his name? It's not Geralt. He sounds like the announcer, though, or the narrator for that, if he was really sleepy. And in prison, has got the bracelets on his wrist. Well, those are obviously handcuffs. Look at them. Look at the fancy things on your wrist.
Quentin raises his hands to examine the devices.
They call them humane handcuffs. How about that? Truth is, there ain't nothing humane about them. They zap you real hard the moment you get your hands on a gun. But they sure look nice.
Bisley lowers his hands again and smirks.
Oh, well, okay, I should have checked that out. I can hover over this and get stats on people. Whoa, okay, look at the hit point difference. 44, 81. I gotta talk to her again. Well, that's real unfortunate about them shocking you, but why you in him in the first place?
The orange's face stretches into a broad smile, baring his dentures to the world.
Like everyone, duh. In a black car, under guard.
Ain't no reason to be smart with me.
There's other guys, too. The ones who go through the front door.
He nods at the black winged woman beside him. Her nose wrinkles in displeasure, but she says nothing.
I find you to be highly irritating.
Olafson watches you steadily, her expression calm but also slightly annoyed.
Okay, I can't check her out. Let's talk to Tomoko Kimura.
The thin, pale young woman is sitting at the window, leaning against the illuminator. The glass is slightly fogged with her breath. She turns to you. Her shiny badge reads Tomoko Kimura, physiologist.
Well, greetings.
We've crossed the border. No way back now. Even traveling by the funicular wasn't so thrilling.
The white presses small hands to her blushing cheeks.
Calling people out by their color is a dangerous game, but let's go.
You were thinking, why have no children been born under the dome? I've got a working hypothesis, but I'm not ready to share it yet.
She says softly, as if answering a question you didn't ask.
Ask her if she sees the dark stain on the outer surface of the dome. Excuse me, ma'am, you happen to know what, you got the science mind and all that. You happen to know what that stain is out there?
Kimura peers through the glass in the direction you indicate.
Oh, that's the aircraft that crashed into the dome during the first expedition. I believe that's a wing fragment, and there's some white canvas. What do you think that is? Maybe a parachute?
I sure hope not. That means that person's stuck up there.
The white shakes her head, bewildered.
I just can't believe it. It's all true. We're on our way to meet the future.
A couple seconds ago, you talked about we've crossed the border. I'm still in the States. I don't know what you're talking about. We ain't in Mexico now.
Kimura shoots you a surprised look.
You're familiar with the details of the briefing, right? To put it simply, the dome is a selectively permeable environment.
Gesundheit.
The white draws an invisible hemisphere in the air.
Inorganic objects may exit the dome without difficulty, but any living creature dies if transported back to the outside world. That's why we're all stuck here for an indefinite period of time.
Well, I wonder why that happens.
Kimura is eyeing the dome's mesh, glittering in the sunlight.
Supposedly, it's something to do with the atmospheric composition, but it's a weak theory. The difference of the air within the dome is so insignificant as to fall within the margin of error. Or to put it more simply, there is no difference.
Well, that just sounds creepy.
She shoots a quick glance at the silver and lowers her voice.
I heard a rumor, or a conspiracy theory, that we can leave the dome at any time. We've simply been told we can't. If you ever decide to test this hypothesis, don't forget to leave me something in your will.
Okay, then. Thank you for the information, ma'am. Nobody seems to trust this guy. Everybody has pointed at this guy and been like, yeah, he can go fuck himself. But I guess if you're like the politician, Monty James. Yeah, if you're like the politician dude in a group of blue-collar and white-collar workers. Yeah, that makes sense, actually.
Stopping by the door's porthole, you watch as the ground slowly approaches. It looks brown-black through the tinted glass and smoky blue at the horizon. It almost seems like the clouds are pulling apart.
Wasn't so goddamn creepy, it'd be beautiful.
Your eye is drawn to the cluttered eastern section of the dome, where you see a block of warehouses and something resembling an observation deck.
I wonder what they're looking at there. Maybe the storm?
The real dome doesn't resemble its image from the ads at all. There are no snow-white cities or vast highways to be seen here. Looking more closely, you can make out a single lonely road leading north. A few sheds, a radar installation, and the glittering antenna of a radio tower emerge from the mists. Yes, engineers will have plenty of work here.
Well, fuck, there goes me thinking it'd be easier than working on the farm.
Just as you're about to move away from the window, you notice a whirlwind beginning to form above the ochre plain. The gathering storm drifts unhurriedly above the desert, a crown of green lightning flashing at its core. Clearly no ordinary weather phenomenon. It must be one of those anomalies. You freeze by the window, unable to avert your gaze.
stand up on my tiptoes, try to make out the buildings below. Stay where you are, trying to see if you can spot the mysterious forefather structures. Stay at the window and watch the whirlwind. I think I'm going to check out that weird storm with the green lightning a little bit longer.
The outlines of the landing site, blurred by clouds of dust, appear behind the greenish glass of the portal. The capsule shudders as the braking devices engage.
How's the game audio? Is it coming through for you? Because so far the sound design on my end sounds pretty good. The hydraulic sounds of the elevator coming through real well. Let's get out of here. Camera controls. WASDA, alright. Return to standard view, hit tab. Okay, I can rotate, move the camera. Ted, did you get a bonus last week? Alright. Your guy just kind of like semi-runs everywhere he goes.
Come on now, or you'll miss everything.
A cheerful man in a white lab coat grabs you by the sleeve. A badge reading Ludovico Nuzzi, scientific analyst, export department, dangles loosely on his clean uniform, which still smells pungently of washing powder.
Look over there!
He points upward with a sharp, wide gesture and hands you his field binoculars.
I don't mind seeing what's wrong. Let's see what he's looking at.
You raise the binoculars to your eyes. Under fourfold magnification, the whirling cloud above the rust-colored plains looks even stranger. Its core glows with flickering green light and flashes rhythmically, and that rhythm seems to form a complicated pattern.
Is that Morse code?
Nuzzi bends close to your ear.
Fascinating. Do you want me to bring some filters? If we intercept the red and blue spectrums, we'll see something amazing. It's like a signal, some kind of message.
I was just thinking that. That's crazy you said that, sir. But what's that on the ground?
Without tearing your gaze away from the binoculars, you turn around slowly, studying the dome's horizon. It's somewhat unexpected that the dome looks horribly empty. Your eyes find some construction pits dug directly in the sand, and concrete blocks laid beside them. There are almost no roads, or not sealed ones. Only one highway with yellow surface marking stretches among the sand drifts.
Well, it's very empty, very desert-like. What's your job, export department?
The scientist looks blankly at you, then down at his lab coat.
This?
He lets out a blaring laugh. Ludovico points at the building behind him.
I work in Concord Station, categorizing relics. My job is to classify them by rarity. Then the blues package them, silvers issue the documentation, and oranges move them to the cargo capsule. Just like the one you arrived in.
Oh, okay. Good to know. So I'm going to be packaging them.
Nuzzi points upward.
Then the capsule takes the relics way up there, all the way to the spire, then to Crystal Sands by the funicular. They get auctioned off, turned into money. It's not like I endorse this, but we all like ourselves a good paycheck, right?
I do like me some money.
He offers you his binoculars once again.
Do you want to have a look at the spire? It's amazing. But then, you can look at the spire anytime. Now that sandstorm, that's what's truly amazing.
Well, that's all nice, but I gotta get my registration done. Thanks for talking, though, Nuzzi.
Nuzzi looks from you to the capsule and to the landing terminal entrance. He flings his arms up.
Oh, mi scusi. Excuse me. I'm so sorry. You'd better get going or you'll be late for check-in. Your colleagues are already inside, and the storm is growing stronger.
Well, yeah, thank you.
The storm is growing stronger.
The white mutters in fascination, eyes glued to his binoculars, which is fixed on the spinning whirl of clouds.
Have fun looking at dust, I guess. What was that? Did I see a middle finger option?
Attention, attention. Please handle relics carefully. In case of damage, your life will be forfeit.
Get the volume just a little bit higher for the game, see if that does anything for it. Transition, examine. Okay, I thought that was a middle finger. I was like, that's an interesting option. Throughout the game, you will perform various tests which lead you through the story as well as reveal different aspects of life under the dome. You can always find out by going to the data section. Let's go to the door. Hi there. Where am I going? The young Blue is closely studying a communication schematic in his Caris. A bundle of wires is hanging from an open fuse box nearby. He smells strongly of cheap cigarettes. His shiny badge says, Tian Yuan, Communications Engineer.
How can I help?
What's your thoughts on this place? Yuan tugs at the blue collar cutting into his neck. The idea itself is impressive, but the execution suffered from failures. It's obvious the capitalistic system is obsolete and cannot support such grand-scale projects. Well, thanks. Have a good time. Didn't mean to get into... Well, what are you doing out here, actually? If you're a communications expert, I don't see no satellite dishes. He taps slightly on his screen. I'm trying to calculate the optimal route for telecommunication cables. These cables connect the entire dome. Here at Concord, they form a hub and run all the way up to the spire. Yuan's face turns very serious. This cable is the only thing connecting the dome to civilization. After the dome was created in 1971, with the beginning of international cooperation on its development, a thaw ensued in the Cold War. The Doomsday Clock Minute has been pushed back and now shows 18 minutes before midnight. Ooh. It's been a long time since the Doomsday Clock has been that big. This cable is the only thing connecting the dome to civilization, and if it happens to break... The engineer looks at you meaningfully. Well, let's hope it doesn't happen. Therefore, my mission is to ensure a stable connection and a secure line, which is impossible without proper documentation. The way they're doing it here is a shame. A person could do time for that back where I come from. Mollify, move right here to help the local infrastructure from falling apart. Don't even worry about it. I'm here to help you. I'm a real expert at these kind of things. Yuan regards you with respect. He puts the communicator away in his pocket and points at the bundle of cables. Look at this shoddy work. First, the wires aren't shielded. Second, the signal's fading. Third, clearly this was done in an awful rush. No matter how much of a rush there was to finish this, such negligence is unacceptable. And I'm not surprised. This is the predictable result of using forced orange wing labor. Do you have any questions for me? He flexes the corner where it's cutting into his neck. I've learned a good deal, thank you very much. Thank you for understanding. I'm not used to getting distracted and sloppy, especially on such important issues. He returns to calculations on his Kara's screen.
I hope to see you again soon.
Dig into the trash. Find $5, why not? Empty beer bottle. Nope. Why am I digging through the trash? Restroom. I can search toilet. No, I'm not going to search a toilet. I'm good. Janitor's gear. Rubbing alcohol. A bar of soap. And a piece of cloth. I'm sure I can make some kind of bomb out of that. Why not? Hand dryer, wash basin, mirror. Various actions, such as eating food or taking medicines, may impose certain status effects on you. This can last for different times and be positive or negative. Some attacks and abilities can also apply status effects. Wait, seriously? Self-confidence. I looked into a mirror and I got a buff. You posed in front of a mirror for a while and were pleased with what you saw. You will enjoy heightened self-confidence. What happens if I use a wash basin? Gets vigorous. Thirst quenched. I drank water from... Go get him, Tiger. Initiative, heat resistance. Wow, there's a stat for everything. Character. Okay, encumbrance. Rads. Good. There's hunger. There's thirst. There's a need for water. I have no need for water. I'm a little bit hungry. I'm kind of tired. Oh, no, I'm not tired at all. I'm wide awake. Okie dokie. Perks, stats. Inventory. They have real emphasis on the bulge right there. This thing must be vacuumed onto the body. Looks like I have a power armor option. Hat, jacket, pants, shoes. I'm gonna guess that's like tech implants. Dual wielding, gloves, belt, backpack, bat. Can't equip anything quite yet. Data. Newcomer to Concord. Okay, so this is my missions. Miscellaneous. This is all the pop-ups. Let's put those away before I get annoyed by the pop-up there. My story. You're one of them, who knows, perhaps we'll discover something to change of mind. You've always been a good technician, so your admittance to the Blue Wing was never... Okay, so talking to those people inside the elevator helps fill out my story. Alright. Reputation. Because I talked to the guy at the front door, I have plus 15. Alright. Map. Dome. Where are we in the dome? Roughly the center. Alright. Can I snap the camera to me is the real question. Oh, Monty, what's up? A silver wearing thick glittering spectacles is sitting in an orange couch, nervously fingering his badge, which reads Monty James. He was on the elevator with us. A large suitcase rested at his feet with a leaflet about the dome perched on top.
Glad to meet you.
Oh, it's you. How do you like it inside the dome? So you're not ready to answer, not enough time has passed. Well, I just got here, so can't really give an opinion. I've seen the lobby. Monty stares moodily down at his suitcase. My first impression is unfortunately not very positive. They forgot to add my name to the new recruit manifest. Could you imagine? Offer to try and register him in the terminal. Are you for real? That would be incredibly kind of you. Why not? Maybe my optimism about this place and the people working here are justified after all. You evidently cheered him up quite a lot.
Bye-bye.
Alright. Terminal.
Your Selectron has not been properly authorized.
Okay.
Please visit the reception.
A tall receptionist watches you from behind his desk with a bored, haughty look. He waves impatiently at you to approach. The employee glances at you indifferently. His upper lip is ever so slightly curled in contempt.
This guy sounds like a real pleasure to talk to.
All new employees must register first thing. Come up to the desk, please.
The nameplate on the desk tells you you're talking with Dean Rayhet, administrator.
He would sell his mother.
The administrator slaps himself on the forehead.
Ah, I almost forgot the regulation pre-registration greeting. Just a second.
His voice also sounds familiar.
Rayhet produces a reel-to-reel tape recorder from beneath the desk, rewinds the tape to the beginning, and presses play. The speakers explode with a harsh, crackling sound, over which the tick-tick of a metronome slowly grows louder. Solemn music begins to play, and the administrator's face takes on a serious expression.
Dear employee, on behalf of the Cronus Foundation, I, Administrator Dean Rayhet, welcome you to your new life under the dome.
Yay! Well, thank you for your introduction.
The administrator clears his throat and continues.
By joining our company, you choose the path of science and progress. You are among mankind's best, and we ask that you live up to this.
I'll do my best.
Dean squints down at the monitor.
Deserve this title. Do your job honestly. Obey the law. Respect your colleagues and...
The music fades, and the administrator finishes his speech.
And together we will build the best possible future for all mankind.
Well, that's quite the speech there, sir.
Dean puts the tape recorder away.
Now that we're done with the official greeting, I'll register you and upgrade your Selectron. Okay?
Well, sounds like a plan, sir.
Dean's hands hover over the keyboard. He gives you a nod.
Dictate your information to him.
You spell out your first and last names and specify your wing, profession, and test results. The administrator's fingers fly across the keyboard as he enters your information into the Cronus database. Rayhet scans the computer screen.
So your position in the waiting list was 63,784. You've been assigned to Magellan Station. A special bus will bring you there after a series of briefings. Please pass me your Selectron so I can update the firmware.
Dean snaps the docking port of your pass to a recess in the casing of his computer. The administrator returns your Selectron.
Now you have first level clearance for a Blue Wing employee. You have access to storage, the repair bays, and various workshops. Your Selectron also has a built-in universal key that opens the hatches accessing the air shafts.
I'm assuming because I'm an engineer.
Dean continues.
All new employees have a short list of tasks to perform on arrival. Do you want to hear all the details or just the short version?
Well, I'm already a bit late today, it feels like, sir, so if you can give me the short version.
Rayhet snorts.
To make it short, get your uniform from storage, your weapons from the armory, pass the Psi abilities test, and complete your weapons training at the training zone. Then learn how to use the scanner, avoid anomalies, and properly catalog anything you observe. Last, go to the waiting room and wait for the bus to Magellan.
Thank you very much.
Dean sits back in his armchair.
That's it. I hope there aren't any questions.
No, sir.
Rayhet claps his hands in satisfaction.
Great.
He reaches for the tape recorder, but thinks better of it.
Protocol calls for a little welcoming preamble, but dash it all, that's nonsense. Welcome to Concord Station.
I appreciate you skipping that, sir.
As he's about to turn away, Dean suddenly remembers something.
Oh yes, I sent your mail to your Kairos. Check your new messages. Well, that's all, I think.
This guy's level 3 and I still have more health than him at level 1. I must be tanky as hell. Messages sent to your various game characters are stored in the message section of your Kairos. Messages from employee computers also end up here. All new messages are in the inbox tab after reading or moved to the archive tab. Alright. Let's go over here, use my new Selectron. Register Monty James. Apparently Cronus sees its managers as a special caste. Once you've double-checked your input, you press send. With a beep, the system accepts the data and redirects you to the main menu. We're gonna log out. Hey, Monty.
Mr. Rayhet, would you bring me a cup of coffee?
Added you to the database, good sir. Monty takes off his spectacles, rests them on the cushion beside him, and envelops you in a big hug. Oh, you sweaty bastard. He puts his glasses back on. Thank you so much. Thank you for such an impressive example of cooperation with the stranger. Perhaps the dome really is a special place.
It was nice chatting.
And he left his suitcase. Am I the kind of guy to break open a suitcase? No. At least not yet. I have yet to be given a reason to feel that.
Good day.
See a slim, cheekbony silver woman, the red warning lamp on her head, in her hands. On the lapel of her perfectly ironed suit is a badge that says Anna Leroy, Administrator. A girl waves her lamp in the air, trying to attract some attention. Valued employees, according to the administrative order of September 14th, 1976, the waiting area has been accessed, may be accessed through the regular staff corridor. Please be advised that this rule does not apply to newly arrived employees. She pauses and begins to cough. Shit, I should probably cut down on the smokes. Good day, new employee. The silver nods, like she's depressed. She seems to have just noticed you. Ask if I can go through the hall in the waiting room. I'm just gonna walk away. Well, good day to you too, ma'am. Later.
Have a good one.
Hello, sir.
Behind the storage counter, you see a small, neat guy. His gingery hair shines with something like brilliantine. His badge says, Sydney Maynard, storekeeper. The silver perks up at your approach. A thick logbook appears at once from under the counter. Sydney puts on thick glasses that seem to age him 5 decades in an instant and studies the lined pages.
Ooh, I like that descriptor. It's simple, short, and it really gives the idea of what it looks like. I'm gonna use that for a D&D character, I think. It's simple, but it gets the job done.
The silver finally stops and pins down a particular page with his finger.
This is your first uniform requisition, right? You can also purchase any equipment you need for the desert directly from me.
Well, really now? Like, legally, or are you just trying to make a side hustle here, sir? Also, can I get my equipment?
Maynard adjusts his glasses in a businesslike manner.
Before I give you the uniform, please listen to these short instructions.
Does everything here require instructions, sir? Oh, never mind, I'll listen.
Sydney fiddles with his hairstyle.
So, I'm not going to sugarcoat it. Life under the dome can be dangerous. You may get shot, spill acid on yourself, get electrocuted, or suffer the effects of a dangerous anomaly. You may also freeze to death or get fried.
I mean, that sounds horribly dangerous.
That's why it's important to wear protective equipment when traveling outdoors. Of course, in hazardous situations, the equipment will get damaged, and the more it's damaged, the more often one has to repair it.
The silver steps back from his counter to indicate the repair kit boxes piled in the back of the warehouse. He points back at the shelves behind him.
We've got repair kits for this gear. There are blue wing specialists ready to help you at any large base, of course, but they're not always available, so you'd better learn how to use repair kits and workbenches on your own. It's a useful skill.
I am part of Blue Wing, so I imagine I'm going to learn how to fix all this anyways.
Sydney rests the logbook on the desk.
That's all the instructions. Now I'm going to issue your uniform.
Well, thank you kindly.
The silver disappears into the back for a while and returns with a small package. Unfolding the package, Maynard shows you a brand spanking new uniform. Sydney half unfolds the clothes, a jacket, high boots, and turnip pants with patch pockets.
The technician's uniform screams function over fashion. Parts of the uniform are rubberized to protect you while working with electricity.
I'm gonna guess that's in-game speak for, hey, you have bonus resistance to electricity.
He raises a finger.
One more important thing. In accordance with Order 16-225, helmets and gloves are not issued, but they're available for purchase from me. Please bear in mind that a full set includes headgear or a mask, jacket, trousers, gloves, and boots.
Sydney hands you the package.
Here's your uniform.
Jacket, enjoy. Pants, boots, leave. Okay. Jacket, pants, boots. I'm missing gloves and mask. Let's go to my inventory. Aviator jacket. Okay. Boots. Oh, I gotta get some more drip than that. Belted pants. Oh, wait, let's see the stats on these. Aviator jacket, evasion, mechanical resistance, energy resistance. So yeah, I definitely, by the looks of this, plus 15. Stand. Movement speed. Daedalus boots? Alright. It's just kind of everywhere, it seems. We're gonna open this box up. Duct tape, crafting item. That just looks like junk. I don't know though. If looking in a mirror gives me status effects, I imagine a match might actually be useful. And that's a container to put my stuff in.
Maynard. Why not? Puts his glasses on again.
You again? Pretty sure you got your uniform already. Anything else I can do for you?
Say you're interested in see what he has for sale. Well, I'd like to see if I can get myself one of them hats and gloves you were talking about.
Sydney adjusts his glasses.
Sure, I'll show you what we've got. You know, we're pretty well stocked here in Concord. Take a look.
Sydney scribbles something in his logbook.
Please come back anytime if you need something.
Definitely don't like that. But that matches what my character has in the picture. Take that. Gloves. Soldier's gloves. Isolator engineer gloves. Work gloves. Go with that. Wait, I don't, maybe not have enough money for that. Go with that. I'm gonna give you some duct tape. Oh no, my charisma's so low. Need some matches. And how about this bar of soap? And then I guess some money. Oh boy. Okay. Low charisma. I feel it now. Food. Oh, food's expensive. Wait a minute. Oh, this is gonna hurt. It is what it is, though. Inventory. We're gonna put on my hat now. Hell yeah. Look at that. Real swag. Got the work gloves. I look like any secondary background villain worker. Let's go.
Anything urgent, Mr. Krachkov?
Katarzyna, did you mark it as class 1 again instead of 2? Look, here's the scanner data. It says the relic is a scientific device.
Wait, but it's still class 1. I'm not going to violate protocol.
Katarzyna, my dear. You may violate protocol as long as it benefits the company. Take your lead from your colleagues. Correct your report if you have to, and don't act so innocent.
Vladimir, I'm done. How do we mark it?
Class 2 fragile. Tell Noyan the relic should go out with today's
attention,
flight.
Think
about it. A class 2 relic
will
make a bigger payoff for the company.
In case
and that
damage,
means a bonus in your wages. Categorizing it as class 2 means...
Oh, this is all sketchy as hell.
Bids. I bet the Brits will buy it. They're always trying to one-up us.
All right, Mr. Krachkov. I'll correct my report.
Carl, add sealed bids to the marking.
Oh, that was just all sketch. Okay. Let's search the trash can. Scissors. Got my shank ready. Let's go. Talk to this lady over here real quick. Give me my weapon.
The smell of good tobacco wafts off this tall, portly woman from a meter away. A black lacquered pipe, an open logbook full of signatures, and a metal flip calendar sit on the counter in front of her. A small nameplate reads, Margarita Tukachenko.
I like that name.
The woman fixes her coppery hair with one hand and casually lights her pipe.
To what do I owe the pleasure?
Her voice is deep and gravelly.
Yeah, I've been informed that I'm supposed to pick up a weapon from you. I'm an engineer, but supposedly they're needed.
Margarita thumbs back a couple of pages in her logbook.
I see. This was your first receipt.
Yes, ma'am. Just arrived today.
She glances at her Kairos, looks at you, snorts, and retreats to the shelves. The Black returns a couple of minutes later with a big baton.
Here you go. This thing's indispensable in close combat.
Well, I prefer that, I guess.
She swipes the baton through the air, then rolls it between her hands with clear satisfaction.
Like it? Enjoy.
Yes, ma'am. I have no issue with this.
Margarita lets out a big puff of smoke and shakes her head.
Shift it to the side, silly Billy, or you'll trip over it.
Ask about service in the weapon. It's a baton, but let's ask. Well, ma'am, do you have any lubricating oil for this thing?
The Black chuckles.
Listen, a baton is a baton.
I figured as much. What issues with it besides being close range?
Dukachenko removes the pipe from her mouth and releases a stream of smoke.
Yes, this thing has one drawback. It doesn't shoot.
Well, you seem happy, ma'am. Have a good time with your pipe.
The armorer shrugs, puffing indifferently on her pipe.
It's the least I could do. We have a requisition list from the Silvers. For free, you receive only rubbish. If you want the real deal, check out the weaponry shop. Or me.
Leaning over the counter, the Black points somewhere off to one side.
Now it's time for your training. Fatherby is already waiting for you by the big gate. He's a bit dotty, but a good man nonetheless.
Well, thank you for the info.
But before the training zone, go see that wizard guy with his toothpicks. Be careful around him, though. Don't let him pitch you a line. Psychic my ass.
She winces in disgust.
Well, that's, Encaps a simple mod of public keys that you can't play much. Hold shift down to view more detailed information. Control to attack characters and doors. So that's like to force an attack. Alt to highlight interactive objects on the ground. That's always going to be useful. Flower pot. Crates, metal locker, armored door. Okay. Let's check out this janitor gear. See?
Complain to the Silvers about that idiot. They'll take the appropriate measures.
Broom. No, mop. As a weapon? 9 to 23 damage. My dude must be yoked.
I hate those oranges. What the hell do they break like?
An engineer in a bright blue jacket is tinkering with the door lock, cursing under his breath nonstop. Blowing a curly strand of hair off his forehead, he turns to you.
You're a newcomer, right? It's a straight-up open house here today.
He offers you his hand. According to his badge, this is Maxime Penkovsky, technician.
Nice to meet you, Pinkowski.
The technician slaps the door with one hand.
You have to wait until I'm done. Some orange jammed up the lock with chewing gum just for a laugh. They're like animals, those oranges, marking their territory. If you ask me, they're too gracious about those bastards in Crystal Sands.
Can you open the door? Or is it really stuck by gum?
Penkovsky grunts angrily.
I wish I could. I'm gonna have to disassemble, clean, and reassemble it to get it working. It's work I don't need, and all thanks to some idiot.
But it's gum, sir. How's the door broken by gum?
Maxime extracts a thin, sharp, precision probe from behind his ear and dangles it in front of you.
What is that?
Though there's another way. You want to learn something about picking locks? It's a useful skill in all sorts of situations.
He looks at you expectantly.
Well, I'm forgetful, so I'll probably lose my keys somewhere, so why not?
The Blue's getting excited.
All right, looky here.
Penkovsky presses his pick lock, and an odd device resembling a hybrid of a screwdriver and a can opener into your hand.
Using a mechanical pick lock is easy peasy. No special skill required. They wear out after a few locks. while the old-fashioned kind is another thing entirely. Cheap, one use. But one has to know how to use it right. That's a tool for a master.
Maxime takes out another picklock and crouches by the door. He gives you a quick lesson on how to pick a lock.
By the way, you can carry your tools in your belt. It's much handier to have them right there.
Penkovsky shows you his utility belt, where he keeps all kinds of tools and gadgets.
Okay. I think I also have a belt.
Actually, finding tools under the dome is no problem at all. There are even devices for hacking terminals and so on.
Maxime hoists up his belt. The blue solemnly raises his index finger.
And one more thing. Always use brand name stuff if you can. Groovy produces good kits. Modus and Supercolor do too. They've all got fat contracts with Cronus, so they care about quality.
I'm not so sure about that one.
He looks at the door again.
Damn these locks. Though I'd rather be doing this than fixing hab pods. Those are a real pain in the ass.
What's wrong with the hab pods?
Penkovsky gives you a patronizing look.
Because they're poorly made, warped from the heat, and the filters aren't worth a damn. The modules were constructed by marketing managers, not engineers. Building a city in the desert was also their idea. This project is all about PR. Cronus wants to show the world how tough they are.
I mean, that might be true, but I got someone I gotta go meet. Thank you for the conversation. The game. Use the right button to unlock door and select the desired ability from the list. To use the special lockpicks, increase the chance of success, but also deplete after rather quickly. In addition, you can break down the door with brute force. If there's a terminal nearby, try to open the door with that instead.
Remember, our honest work will make the world a better place.
I repeat, get a lockpick and attach it to your utility belt, and then, apply it to the door. Yes, apply is the proper word.
And belt. Oh yeah, put that in my hand, by the way. Add to belt. Ammo? Oh, it's a caffeine. A stimulator that increased vigor, so it reduces my fatigue. Okay. Are these sleeping pills? Steroid drug. When did I get that? Who's just giving me drugs? There we go.
Just don't forget to pick up your uniform and weapons. It'll be awkward for you if the door gets stuck again.
Okie dokie, got my weapons. Let's talk to this magic man she was talking about. Hello, sir.
A lean silver with thick black hair and a huge cigar clamped in his teeth is sitting in front of you. As you approach, he flashes a sly grin and slowly raises an outstretched hand above the table. Something really weird happens. All the paper clips, pencils, scattered toothpicks, and bits of trash float up from the table and hang in the air. The silver badge reading Andre Mihai, Science Instructor, floats up as well.
Good sir, what kind of witchcraft are you dealing with?
The silver trills with laughter. He approves of your reaction. The objects fall back to the tabletop with a light clatter.
Here for the briefing, huh? Shall we get to it?
He takes the cigar out of his mouth and exhales a lush cloud of smoke.
You know we're in the 70s because everyone is smoking indoors. Like, yeah, you have what I'm assuming is fake potted plants. You have very round furniture everywhere. Certain design aspects, like the color choices, don't feel very 70s to me, but like the desk sitting on a small, it's like a nice wooden desk, and then it just sits on a small steel leg right there, how round the furniture is, and like I said, everyone's smoking indoors. Very giving off the era real well. Well, sure, I'm willing to listen about your psychic abilities.
The silver props his elbows on the table.
Anyway, here's the deal. It's more profitable for people with a high psyche to study psionics. Give me your hand.
Okay.
Not waiting for an answer, he grabs your hand with strong, dark fingers. Andre gropes your hand briefly, then lets go, disappointed.
The pills, huh? The anti-migraine, sleeping pills, neuroleptics, downers, what do you mean you don't take them? Well, off you go then. That means no talent, huh? Why waste time? No wasting time now. But alas, regulations demand it, so I'll give you a glove too. Regulations, huh?
The Silver takes a thin glove covered in talc from his desk and passes it to you.
Look, a glove, right? But it isn't just a glove. This is an ooh mama hold me tight glove. It takes energy from your noggin, your psyche, and pew, concentrates it.
That sounds weird.
He counts off on his fingers.
Learn psionics. Put on the glove. Transform energy into the necessary shape. That's the whole briefing. Simple? Simple. Now to your questions, huh?
I'm gonna leave now, sir. You sound crazy. What is my psionic score? Character. Perks. A psyche of 2. Yeah, I have no psychic ability. You're trained in basic work safety, guts, alert ability, melee weapons, contraptions, tech. 4 guts. Plus 5 guts. Wait. I have guts 14. So 10's not the high point. Oh, that's gonna get rough real quick. Like, we'll find out. Inventory? How much can I sell this for? I'm not looking to do any of the psychic mumbo jumbo yet. So we're gonna sell this and see what I can get from the weapon lady over here before we carry on. I'd like a slightly stronger baseball bat.
Dekachenko grunts a greeting without removing the pipe from her mouth.
Just tell me what you want so we can dispense with all the how are yous and phony smiles you're lot so fond of. Straight to business.
Well, you see, ma'am, I've got a new weapon I'd like to sell you and perhaps get me something fancier as well.
Dekachenko opens the big black logbook on the counter.
Why not?
Let's see what you have. I'm gonna give you this here glove that I don't care about. And these scissors, because I'm not a prison shank artist. And we'll see what you got. A whole ass fucking machine gun? Jalapeno pepper spray. A taser. A nail gun? An energy pistol. Was that a hypo needle? Yep. Brass knuckles. That sounds like what I want. Oh, it does less damage. Has better crit, though. Hypnosis sleeping spray. Shinking is a very important life skill. I suggest you learn it. But it's not. I'm not fighting robots, though. And just we have like a machine gun, pepper spray, nail gun, dart gun, and then gun. Air gun propellant. Well, I guess I'm just gonna earn money and sell you this glove that I don't care about. Alright, bye lady. Shanking, yep. Yeah, I can't shank right now currently, I just have a big old baseball bat.
Welcome under the dome, an amazing excursion to a world of new technology and the riddles of an ancient civilization. Listen to this information, useful for all wings, and receive a colorful leaflet.
Oh, I just realized this game's in stereo. Nail gun, yep, give me a long distance shanking. I guess bullets are long distance shaking. There's turrets in the ground.
Welcome under the dome, an amazing excursion to a world of new technology and the riddles of an ancient
civilization. Okay, so machines are weak against energy. Ma'am, I need you to shut up. Initiative, precision, detection time. Well, I have better stats than it, at least. No, I don't.
Welcome under the dome, an amazing excursion.
Ma'am, I'm gonna have to ask you to quiet. Technology and the riddles of an ancient civilization. Listen to Let's check the trash. I'm a janitor. Might be useful for crafting. Maybe I can make a shank. Just straight up. Alright. Hello, sir.
You see a tall scientist in a white lab coat, bathed in the dim lamplight. He almost appears to be hovering above the laboratory floor.
Hello, sir.
The man turns at your footsteps. He's holding a paper clipboard and a pencil. His shimmering silver badge reads Sebastian Van Olden. He glances from you to the glittering watch on his wrist.
I want us to respect one another's time. Please speak loudly, clearly, and to the point. You must be the newcomer I was told about. Nice to meet you.
I mean, yeah, you fold the aluminum can up enough, it's going to do what it has to do. Also, is the game audio coming through pretty clear for you guys? On my my readings here, it looks like it's pretty low, but I'm not looking to blow anyone's ears out. Nice to meet you too, Doctor. What operations training do you have me learning today?
Finished with his unusual greeting, he offers you his thin hand.
I'm here to learn what you need to tell me.
The scientist puts the clipboard aside, raises his watch for a closer look, and sets the timer.
That's not a good sign.
He shows you his watch dial.
According to the rules of this briefing, I have to touch on a large number of topics. Therefore, I will do so very briefly. Do not interrupt me. When I'm finished, I'll answer your questions. Within regulations, of course.
Okay, he's very punctual.
Sebastian produces his handheld and clicks some buttons.
I checked your scanner. It's working and is connected to the Minerva database. Everything you scan will earn you Kronos or Forefathers knowledge points.
What's a for? No questions.
The instructor watches you with displeasure.
Are you listening? Scan everything that might be of scientific interest. First of all, anomalies. They could be dangerous. Make sure to always have medication with you.
He places a canvas pouch in your hand.
This pouch is full of bolts. You can temporarily discharge an anomaly by throwing a bolt into it. It's primitive, but reliable.
Okay, so this is very, very Stalker-esque. I'm just have a bag full of bolts, throwing it into what I'm going to assume is balls of lightning? Yeah, this is Stalker.
Van Olden pushes a button on his stopwatch.
So, my oral briefing fell within the allotted span of time. Any questions you want to ask me?
What are the knowledge points? You said Kronos and four fathers? I only have one father.
The white scowls in annoyance.
Do you know anything at all? What did you come under the dome for anyway? You get knowledge points for scanning objects.
Mm-hmm. Understand that part.
For scanning anomalies and relics, you receive forefather points. Scanning the company's property and employees, living or dead, earns you Kronos knowledge points.
He explains with a sagacious expression.
Okay, I'm following along, sir.
You can exchange knowledge points for medication and equipment as part of the volunteer research program. Are you ready for the next part? The clock is ticking.
The instructor taps his watch meaningfully.
What medications do you think I need for these anomalies?
You'll need some 1-use stimulator injectors, bandages to stop bleeding, and anti-radiation agents and radio protectors, including ARAD 3.
The white ticks these off on his fingers.
Can you write that down, like in a prescription note?
He produces a black-capped, transparent plastic jar out of his pocket.
According to protocol, you should have this medicine. I'll give it to you as soon as we proceed to the practical part of the briefing. Are you ready, by the way, or do you have any questions?
How do I... You know what, I'm good. I'm very confused, and I'll just be wasting your time today.
The scientist glances at his watch again.
You're within the time limit for questions. The next step is training in the artificial eco zone.
The artificial who now? Lacks the Slavic spirit, yeah. I was talking earlier. This is like super 1970s. The Cold War has cut to an end. So, see how you got here a little bit later. The story so far is that while going through the desert, someone found this massive dome. The size of, like, Maryland. And, scientists quickly found out that you can walk in there just fine. But if you leave the dome, you die. Like, instantly. So, the world governments have, like, kind of got together and the Cold War has kind of simmered for a bit. to allow everyone to be flown into this area and taking turns discovering things. And like Stalker, right? They have the anomalies. But there's apparently also relics that I can find, take to a scientist, they can tell me what it is, and then I can sell it for money. Which, again, is a very Stalker-esque thing. So what I'm gathering so far is this is Fallout if the bombs didn't drop, is what I think this is. Roadside picnic, yep. This is the Fallout setting if they discovered the transistor, because that's the big difference in the Fallout setting, is it verges off. We didn't discover, in our world, we discovered the transistor, and using that, we developed smaller and smaller technology as time went on. In the Fallout universe, they didn't. They had to get stuck with, like, specifics. They couldn't get any smaller than a certain size of, like, power transformer and all that. So, like, well, we don't want to keep running electricity through all this stuff. Because if we do that, we're going to have to, like, start making things bigger and bigger. So what if we just put a nuclear power source next to these transformers? Which is the reason they're stuck in that 1950s look.
He rests one finger on the button in preparation to start the timer.
You're going to go downstairs and scan relics. I will be monitoring your progress. Please note there are several radioactive anomalies in the eco-zone. These are the same conditions you'll be working in the field. Radioactive zones and relics are quite common under the dome.
That doesn't sound safe.
He smoothly extracts a jar of yellow pills from his pocket.
Here's your Arad 3. And one more thing. Just a moment.
Oh, okay.
Welcome under the dome. An amazing excursion.
Ma'am, I will bust your face open.
And the riddles of an ancient civilization. Listen to this information, useful for all wings, and receive a colorful leaflet.
Sir? Just a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the dome from the inside with me, Victoria LeGrand. As you can see, there are endless salt pans.
Another mop. The sun reflects blindingly. Bag of drinks. Norman Potter. Dry as a nun's gusset. That's not a word I want to hear. We're just going to walk through this door.
Decontamination to end.
Oh, not a fan of that. Scanning. You have the scanning ability. To perform a scanning, select the ability in the panel, then click on the object that you want to scan. For each successful scan, you receive knowledge points and data obtained in the process stored in the in your Kairos. X. Kairos. Okay, just data. Our uniform. Okay, scan training. Okay, so this is pretty much the last step before I get to actually, like, start. Scanner.
I don't know about you, but I'm sure I'll come here in a year and will feel like a real queen.
Be careful around the anomalies. Touch one of them and you'll be injured.
Cool. Anomalies. I wonder if we're gonna have, bandits? Where's my cheeky breeky at?
Toss a journal entry. A successful scanning attempt. You're doing all right so far. Go ahead. I'll keep an eye on you and make sure you don't screw it up.
Oh, I'm taking rats.
Journal entry. Two objects scanned. And again, watch out for anomalies. Touch one and you'll be injured. Toss a bolt to the anomaly.
Bolt. Yeah. Yeah. Going. Nope. Oh, come on, controls. Pop that. Walk. Secret discovered. Dig. I require a shovel. Scanner. Beep. take out the bolt. Crazy how they're trading their actual radiation hazards, right? It's not simulated in the slightest. It's just, hey, don't touch this or you die. All right, let's go to character sheet real quick and see how bad I did. I'm good. We're good. I only took a low dosage of radiation. We're fine. Everything's okay. Hey, Doc, can you help me?
Sebastian meets you on the platform.
Your finishing time is within the acceptable range.
Thank you.
He clicks the stopwatch button, fixing the result time.
I'm gonna let you talk about what you... Yep, sir.
The scientist turns back to his notes.
Not bad. One question. You observed several anomalies while scanning. Why do you think they appeared? I'd like to hear your opinion.
Well, maybe they can sense electronics.
The scientist assumes a superior expression.
I knew you'd come up with something like that. I see you understand nothing about the nature of anomalies. So let me add a couple of points.
No need to be a dick about it.
He glances at the shimmering blue light in the eco zone.
The truth is, we don't know the precise reason for these phenomenon either. We actually know nothing, no matter how much we try to convince ourselves otherwise.
Well, you don't have to sound like a dick about it then. You don't know nothing. Scientists can be sure assholes, yet.
Sebastian points a thin finger at the clustered lightning.
I personally believe that the anomalies are the dome's security mechanism. The ones you saw are relatively harmless, but there are different anomalies in the desert, phenomena that toy with the human mind.
There's a lot of roadside picnic in this. All the reviews I saw, people were talking about Wasteland 2 and Fallout 2, and no, this is some Chernobyl exclusion zone type nonsense.
Van Olden clasps his hands behind his back.
I know you don't care, but I'll say it anyway. Scientists today are required to be wonder workers who can heal cancer with a wave of their hand and solve the secrets of the universe during their coffee break. For some reason, no one wants to understand that fundamental science is always an investment in the future. It produces no answers here and now.
Understood.
The White's gaze strays back to his clipboard.
If something terrible happens under the dome one day, and I'm sure it will, science will protect no one. That is all. Off you go.
Okay, so that might have come off a little bit weird, seeing how you missed the opening for this game. The dome is cut into five factions, and it's basically like different job groups. The white group, scientist. The orange group are D-class prisoners from the SCP Foundation, basically. I'm a blue class person. I'm like an engineer, technician, electrician. Silvers are like your politician, smooth talkers, administrative types. And the black is security. I feel it's a dangerous move, but they label people the whites, the blues, the blacks. It's pretty strict, because once you get into the... You have to apply to enter the dome, because there are certain benefits to it. The negatives obviously being that you can never leave the dome. But yeah, you step into a certain line of work, and you're there until you die. So yeah, like, I can never be a white scientist. I cannot be a black security or an orange prison. Well, I don't know. Maybe if I fuck up enough, I could become orange. Well, thank you, sir. I'm down one day, and I'm sure it will. Science will protect no one. That is all. Well, at least the guy is not so high and mighty about that prospect. Craft something. I can craft at fire posts. Acquire. I have enough. Okay. Weird. I'm interested. Where do I go next? Let's go to Alt. Military grade medical kit. I'm glad I turned the camera. all the pills, gonna give me all the pills. Energy resistance, biochemical resistance. Okay, so that's my Rad-X. Medkit, instant physical regeneration agent developed by Maximon Company, comes with an injector for quick consumption. Toxic, with potential long-term side effects. Oof. Rad Force, reduces radiation. Okay. My encumbrance is still good. We're good. And keep holding Alt. Out here.
Please stand by for decontamination to end.
I wonder, did that... I doubt it, but I wonder if that removed my radiation. It did. Okay. Let's talk to this guy if I can buy anything from him.
The scientist looks up at you.
Off you go. I'll send a message to the administrator that you received your briefing.
Laser gun. Laser gun. Sword? Trash, relic dust, that reagent box, Rev Plus. Guess I don't really need anything from you. I was kind of hoping I'd get more bolts, but I won't complain. Rad Force, piece of cloth. Okay, leave. Bye, sir. Shooting range. Hello, sir.
A middle-aged black is sitting behind the counter with his hands in his lap. The buttons and zippers on his uniform are polished to a shine, and even his badge, Winston Botherby, instructor, has been buffed so much it hurts to look at it.
We'll take real good care of your uniform there, sir.
Botherby frowns as you approach.
Your first act is being late for the briefing. You going to be late for your funeral as well?
Send me one to receive instruction. Say that you wish to receive military training. I wish to receive instruction, sir.
The black looks you over.
Yes, I see the weapon received checkmark. Looks like you are fully prepared to disappoint me. You are prepared, right, employee?
Botherby leans over the counter and directs you to the doors.
Behind this door is a combat simulation computer. Launch it and begin your course.
He raises his index finger.
The conditions in the training zone closely simulate those one would experience in the field. Your goal is to avoid getting lost and dying of dehydration. And try to aim the barrel away from yourself when shooting.
I wished not to eat a bullet, sir.
Pulling a notepad from his pocket, the instructor jots down your name.
Your goal is to hit three targets. I'm going to monitor you and advise as necessary.
Sir, yes, sir. Preparing for combat. Before entering combat, make sure you're prepared. Check your companion's health. Move your weapon from inventory to the hand slot. Load your gun if necessary. Prepare medicine. Your actions and direction of attack. We'll just make a bloody mess. We're going to ensure that I have health. Health. Okay, that's the health. I'm gonna have to remember that. Add to the belt. Enter Alpha to initiate Alpha Squad hologram. Proceed to training zone. Turn-based combat. Encased has a turn-based combat system. The move sequences of your opponent are less. Played enough of these games to have an idea of how that works. Proceed. We're gonna go to this corner. And I'm going to... I have no AP left. Okay, that's my turn. Enviorment and combat. In almost every battle, you are surrounded by interactive objects. Traps, holes of toxic goo, flames, and or barrels of fuel that can be blown up while I'm shot. Use these to your advantage. Or, hear me out. I can bop this dude in the face. Can't help but say I'm stoked. And he's been bopped. Oh, this guy's gonna bop me in the face. He stepped onto a mine. Bop. Bop. My dude's just a meathead, holy shit. You aren't completely hopeless. Skip. I wonder if he takes disadvantage if I am in close range while he's on. What's on alert mean? We're gonna save some AP. Let him come at me. Shoot. All right. Everybody goes about their business. Come here. Bonk. Bonk. Let's go. Put away my weapon. Hello, sir.
Bother be nods, grandly.
You made it through training without making a total fool of yourself.
Congratulations.
I'll send a report up the chain about your completely unanticipated success. You're dismissed.
Well, that guy's a total dick. Well, thank you, sir. Saved. Where do I go to now? Nelson Cunningham. Attention, attention. Please handle relics carefully. I haven't heard one kind word yet. The first guy. The guy that gave me my uniform. He was a nice dude. And the other blue guy who taught me how to lockpick. He was also nice. An impassive man, his long gray hair in a bun, smokes a cigarette, dropping ash on his boots from time to time. The headphones hanging around his neck produce some metal music.
Glad to meet you.
The dull badge on his chest reads, Nelson Cunningham, Burial Manager. Nelson takes a cigarette out of his mouth. Hi, are you feeling good? It's a professional interest. Man, I wonder what these boxes are for. Boxes? What a thing to say. Boxes? These are coffins. Nelson reacts as if you insulted him deeply. He approaches one of the containers. These are the best coffins I've ever seen. Here, a window to look at the dead. Want to open or close it? Can do. Here's a latch to stop the lid from falling. Alright, technology. Maybe I'm the dick now because this guy's just fucking weird. Cunningham swings open a coffin lid. Fortunately, this one is empty. Shaft, comfortable, is soundproof. Can sleep in it all white. Wanna try? I feel if I say no, he's gonna attack me in my sleep. So I'm gonna agree and lay down in a coffin. Okay, lie down, just don't... Nelson lets you approach the coffins. Okay, lie down. Just don't touch the latches. They act up sometimes. Lie down in the coffin like Snow White from the cartoon and ask for an apple. Oh yeah. We're gonna be real smart ass. Well now, do I get my apple? The blue lass. No, I wanted to go buy me a coffee. I could bring you some. Want a coffee? No? Well, alright then. I'll be back soon. Oh, he's gonna leave me in the fucking coffin. The lid swings shut, and with a bang, you hear a soft metal click. Oh no. You lie still while inside the coffin, listening to the complete silence. Nelson was right. Sleeping here must be really comfortable. Though you can't see why a coffin should be soundproof. I don't like this guy. hello? A- anyone out there? Shit, it's soundproof. Can I open this? That's right. I'm muscly and smart. Look for an inside latch that might open the coffin. Rock the coffin so it falls and attracts someone's attention. Brace yourself against the cover and try to break. We're gonna tech our way out of this one. Well, if I know anything about mechanics, there should be a latch in case someone was just in a coma. Right about here. You hastily search for inside the coffin for some kind of latch. Unfortunately, the solution is not provided for. Fuck, damn it. Maybe I can break it open with my muscles. Seems more solid than it looks. Alright, well, maybe they'll think I'm alive. This is the coffin's too confined, it's too heavy, you can't advance. Bang on the lid and cry for help. Oh shit, I want my mama! Not bad, which means that not only can you hear nothing from the people outside, they can't hear you either. Suddenly feel the coffin being raised and almost immediately placed onto something solid. Judging by the light, you're being oh shit. Am I dead? Did my character just die? Soon the bumps stop and you feel the coffin being shifted again. Oh fuck, don't incinerate me. A few seconds later, you sense heat. A square of crimson light is glowing ever stronger before your eyes. It's a metal screen covering the coffin's window. Yeah, really like this guy. Really like this guy. Speedrun. Speedrun. Fuck, when did I save last? Okay. I don't know how long ago that... Coffin. Coffin percent. Load. Did I quick save by accident just outside the door? Wow, that... Coffin percent. Fuck me. Yeah, you quicksave like right before the coffin boy. Lucky me. Yeah, because the next one was like a whole hour before this. Well, time to get me a take a drink real quick. Holy shit. Lucky me. We're gonna talk to this guy again, but I'm not getting into the fucking coffin. The game's got jokes killing you in the tutorial. Oh yeah, it has a real smart aleck sense of humor, from what I'm gathered.
Come on, don't be shy.
Ask him what he's doing here. Prepare these coffins. Wonder what the boxes are for. The best coffins I've ever seen. Here's a window. Look at the dead. Want to close? Open it. Refuse. Ask Nelson to lie down in there himself. Shoot yourself. I personally do like lying in these sometimes. He lies down in the coffin, rolls back and forth a few times, gets comfortable in the velvet cushion. Sure good. I hide from the Bosch sometimes. Close the lid and go to sleep. I'm a better person. A couple of minutes, the light pops open from a powerful blow, and the blue rises from the coffin. Roaring, his arms outstretched. Like a zombie, alright, yeah? I'm just gonna leave this guy. I feel he's gonna murder me more. I just realized also, I got an achievement for dying in the coffin. That's now permanently labeled. Like, the stream, I can edit this out. Ask him to lie down in the coffin again, then leave him. Oh, I'm a better person. Lock the latches on the lid. His voice is almost totally inaudible. Wait a bit. Unlock. Then let him free. Wow, don't you joke like that again. Later, dude.
Have a good one.
Dick. Properties, examine, janitor's gear. We're gonna search your shit over here.
Hey you. Yeah, you dumbass.
quit staring and get over here. I'm talking business.
Sir, I will beat you.
Hey, you. Yeah, you dumb.
Before you, you see a large hairy orange with funny rounded little glasses. He has a pack of fishnets in his hand and dips his fingers in it, carefully fishing small pieces out. Daryl Gilmore, loader, says the badge on his chest.
Salutations.
He resettles his glasses on his nose and looks quickly around. Then he puts an arm around your shoulder and pulls you in. Alright, long story short, kitten, I have one offer. A business offer. You smell what I'm cooking? Okay, here's the thing. You see that wall behind my back? I've just returned from there. From shipping. I've been moving some crates. They weren't sealed for transit yet, so I've checked a few of them out. And looky, looky, there are relics inside. I thought they were rubbish at first, but no. These are solid, genuine relics. Category 2 as well. Hold on. Daryl scoops a handful of orange-dyed crumpled something out of his pack and puts it in his mouth. He chews and swallows, then goes on. Anyways, I can't get these crates. I can't get to the crates. They are gods. But you look at the sort who would easily blend in. Would you sneak in all fancy-like and grab something that's lying about? Don't forget about me, of course. Fresh out, son of a bitches, the main thing you should remember is to go quietly. Don't get caught on camera and don't let the gods see you. It's gonna be okay. I'm fine. Thank you, though. You should at least think about it, kitten.
See ya.
Yum yum. Guts, lower initiative regeneration, fortitude resilience, close quarter damage, learn ability. Don't blow him, right? Detection time. 7, 6, 10, 10. What's his health at?
Attention, attention. Please handle relics carefully. In case of damage.
74. I won't fuck with him. I'm not gonna go for a dickhead run for the first run. Though I will die in a coffin, it seems. Saving.
Hey, you're at it again, asshole.
Okay, you got me, Butch. Old habits. You know that.
Shall we continue?
Continue my ass. Great deal. Everyone gets 3 bolts.
Hey, come on now. Start over. You only did it once.
No, Butch is right. I ain't gonna argue with him.
Of course you ain't, you slime.
This is the kind of world building I like.
Find out you cheated. Your mama won't ever see you again.
None of our mothers will ever see any of us again. Damned dome. I'm all right. I'm dealing.
Yeah, by the way, you can get a buff from looking at a mirror. It increases your self-confidence, which gives you better charisma. And by washing your body, you get higher initiative and heat resistance. Clearly, you've interrupted some kind of game. The three oranges freeze, their arms outstretched, staring at you perplexedly. Hey, what are you fellas playing? Wrong voice. Well, howdy there. What are you fellas playing? One of the oranges gives a twisted smirk. We work hard, and we rest just as hard. We've got a break, see? So we're making small talk. You need something? Mind if I play with y'all? The nice little details, yep. You know, there's something about you I just don't like. You better get on out of here. Say you don't want to interrupt him and leave. Oh yeah, we're going too. Time for work, right guys? The oranges share a look and hastily withdraw, leaving you behind. Hand dryer. Is there a buff for using a hand dryer? Dry and warm. Oh, hell yes. Janitor gear. Maybe there's something of use. More mops. I find it funny that a mop can do 28 damage, which tells me that 28 damage isn't a lot. Hi there, sir. Just to talk to you real quick. A short, skinny technician is working among the warehouse shelves. With his eyes glued to the stack and stacks of cases, he's frantically writing something on his notebook. His badge says Merrick Dinkovsky on it. I was waiting for it to be Ishtar.
You again.
You clap him on the shoulder, but he just hisses in your direction without looking. Abbott, please, it's not funny anymore. Well, there, you happen to need any help?
I'm all ears.
Oh, Jesus, I'm sorry, I mistook you for my idiot co-worker. Help, you say? I could use some help. You know how to use a scanner? And take inventory? If so, you can absolutely help me. I have 6 relics inside the cases on these tables. You could scan them for me and write the data in this notebook, on the table as well. Yeah, you can absolutely help me like that. Thank you. We only met 2 minutes ago, but you're already better than Abbott. How amazing is that?
See ya.
Scan. Nope, how do I cancel? Put the weapon away. What the hell is N1? Scanning. Fill in the notebook. Move away. Scan multiple. Look at that bulky ass scanner. Scanner time. So yeah, these are those relics I was talking about, where apparently this company, Kronos, is selling these for a decent chunk of money. And you can only find them in the anomalies. Alright, let's add this all to the, I'm just getting free experience. I'm not gonna complain about that. Let's go. Go in the notebook. Looking at the table, you see that all the fields have been filled in. You put away the notebook. Hey, buddy, done. Discuss the task.
You again.
Tell him you finished. Wow, excellent work. I'm impressed. I'm impressed, even. I'm not accustomed to people actually doing what they're told. Thanks for the help. You step aside and Dinkovsky looks back at you and waves affably.
Come back again.
That's all gone. Let's check out... Is it just guns, or can I make a better melee weapon? Shiv! We found the shiv! I sold the scissors! We know there's a shiv now, though. That's gonna happen. You fool. It's cool. I'll search the trash cans real quick. It's not over yet. You fool, no! How dare I? I joked about a shiv. Didn't think there was actually gonna be a fucking shiv option. Okay, over here. Check the vacuum cleaner. Janitor gear. Mop. Nope. Trash bin. Scissors. And money. Okay. I just need to find duct tape now. I can craft a shiv.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the dome from the inside.
An amazing excursion to a world of new
technology. I'm going
to
use the shiv on you.
An ancient civilization. Listen to this information, useful for all wings, and receive a colorful leaflet.
Maybe the guy who runs this shop over here has duct tape?
Winston's leather boots creak rhythmically as he paces back and forth in his office.
Sunbrush, pistol bullet, handgun cartridge. Nope. Okay. We're going to back away from here. Leave. Where's my duct tape? Holographic table. This desk is a bit different from others on this floor. It's covered with a thick layer of cellular glass treated with luminophores. Every little point on the surface emits a weak yellow light, some of them glowing brighter, some dimmer. The work table has a huge built-in display. Rows of glowing points form a detailed map of the area under the dome. You touch the screen with your fingertips, and the static makes the hairs on your arm rise. If she was an android, or is she brainwashed? Let's talk to her. Maybe she'll shut up.
An amazing excursion to a world of new technology and the riddles of an ancient civilization. Listen to this information. Useful. Hi there. Attention.
Attention. She might be brainwashed. The young woman's polished badge reads Letizia Ramirez. She's carrying a stack of glossy leaflets in her arm. You see another stack of leaflets on a nearby armchair. She pounces on you. Ooh woo. Welcome to the dome. I have useful information for all technical department employees. My name is Letizia Ramirez. Give me 5 minutes of your precious time and I'll tell you about the remarkable career opportunities and breathtaking perspectives awaiting you under the dome. Don't turn me down. This is important. Oh wait, she literally pounced on you. Okay, she's weird. Listen. Oh, she wants me to sit? Her free arm in the air with excitement. Exploring the dome is a mission of massive complexity, and its success depends on the technicians, engineers, and programmers of Blue Wing. Not like this. We are happy to welcome you under the dome. You will find the best equipment from best supplies. Stay away from the crazy janitor, bro. We are super happy to welcome you under the dome. Here, you'll find the best equipment from the best suppliers, modern vehicles, advanced telecommunication networks, and the latest computers to aid you in your work with advanced technology. We also provide each employee with a portable computer. If you have an engineering mentality and are fond of solving complex problems, the Blue Wing will be paradise for you. Snooker and beer on Fridays? Thank you for choosing Blue Wing. Thank her for her speech. Say sarcastic, the speech is both incredible, useful, and inspiring. This was nothing but stupid and cheap corporate. Sarcasm. Thank you, that's very kind of you. People usually don't find it all that interesting. Oh yeah, she's crazy. Stay away from the crazy janitor, bro. The girl offers you a colorful booklet. If you were honestly interested in the speech, maybe you'd like to look through the leaflet? The dome is your new home. An exciting read for the entire family. Tell Letizia to fuck off. Take the leaflet. You take a glossy leaflet with colorful pictures on the cover. White and pink houses, palm trees, and luxurious cars. You can't actually find all these things under the dome, though the picture is beautiful. Just a couple more. Hey, how about a few more for your friends? No? Well, all right.
I hope to see you again soon.
Now, the goal of this was to see you not repeat that line again. Oh, wait. Wait, fuck. I don't want to talk to you again, but... Barter. You have nothing. Leave me.
I hope to see you again soon.
Over here. Hey, Maxim, you got any duct tape?
Penkovsky wearily drags a sleeve across his forehead.
Duct tape, give.
And I'm stuck here with the cleaning and repairing. When you get to Magellan, say hi to Duncan for me. Tell him he still owes me that Captain Hyena issue.
Here, take a free pamphlet, buddy. Nope, that's not enough. Okay. Hello, hi there, doing? How you doing, Digital? We're playing some, Encased. So far, with the vibes that we're getting from it are, Fallout meets Wasteland meets Roadside Picnic, or Stalker, as it's also known as. Very interesting. Very interesting. I'm playing like a melee build. And I'm glad to hear you're doing great. And right now I'm trying to learn how to make a shank. Can I sell the tin can? Yes. I'm not making anything off this. Sell that. Okay. Give him more of my money. Is this like XCOM or Shadowrunner? In the way the combat works, yes. But it's much more like an RPG. It's like the original Fallout games, like 1 and 2. I gave you all that for some duct tape. Now I can make a shank. Later. Oh, hello there. Thank you. Welcome to the database. Classic CRPG. Yep. Woozle's got the idea. Craft something. Now he can make the prison shank. Craft one. Now we get to see the prison shank in my inventory because I spent all that time making a goddamn prison shank. Less damage. Because I have criminal points, it does more damage. And it's a 200% crit mod, so this is my emergency weapon. Okay, let's fucking go, boys. Where do I go next, though? Quest. Nope. What's my quest button? V? I need to remember what that hotkey is. Pause. Craft window. Inventory. Quest is L for some reason. Oh! The missions are timed. It's good to know. Nice. How long before combat happens from a new game? Must be after an hour from watching YouTube. Yeah, I've been streaming for about 2 hours. I did spend a solid 45 minutes in character creation. There's not a lot to work with, but I wanted to like figure out exactly what to knock out. But yeah, if I'm reading this correctly, this is timed. I have to get to my specific location in that time or it's over. If you run around to fetch new uniform weapons to the train, finally you're a full-fledged member of Cronus. That has to mean something. Where do I go next, though? Crystal Sands, good technician. Track it. Alright, and then character. I can level up. Abilities. Melee weapon, hand-to-hand. Contraptions. High score in this skill means you're less likely to step into a bear trap and lose your hand in a hidden laser gadget. Explosives. High-tech weapons, psionics. I don't really care about the psionics. Let's go to applied. Tech, criminal, survival. We'll put 2 into survival, get me to 60. We will put a couple into medicine. I'm not looking to die out here. Put a 20 there, and then we'll 2 tech, 1 science, and then we'll even out, we'll just dump a random point into hand-to-hand. Save. Booyashina. Alright. 150 is a weird max for skills. Did the game explain how its math works? For certain things, yeah. So, let's go over here. This feels like 3.5 D&D when I'm reading it. So, for close quarters damage. Yeah, the first hour of character was mostly voice dialogue. Not sure after they cut back on it. A little bit. This has just been getting my equipment and figuring out what the game abilities are, and I feel like it's not in depth enough, oddly enough, because like we were talking right here, bonus damage from melee weapons and in hand-to-hand combat base my level, so I'm level 2 divided by 2, so 1 plus my muscle minus 5, and then that's the bonus damage from just my melee weapons skill, which is guts plus muscle plus whatever modifiers these are giving me. So yeah, it gives me the formulas at least so I can try to track it out in my head. But it's a bit, yeah, the math is weird. I don't know why 150 is the max. I'm under the impression that maybe you can't get everything to max, which would make sense. Who are you? Dennis Catch.
Well, what? Again?
There is a badge on the chest of the black with the inscription, Dennis Catch, guard. He stops you with a gesture. What are you doing? Gate 1's a restricted area. Come on, get out of here. Alright, clearly not where I need to go. Wait, it mentioned something. I want to see if... I don't have the right kind of scanner to scan people yet, it seems. But that is an option later down the line. Okay, so I've done that. Gone through here. Map. Where am I at? I'm right there. Maybe through this way? Yeah, we're gonna go this way and see what that does for me. Have you played Atom RPG? I've played Underrail. I'm a big fan of Underrail. I suck at it, but I love Underrail. My luckiest build with that so far was going like the hardiest tank build I could go and having a spear so that I could get the bonus evasion skill. And even then, I still died to giant crabs the size of refrigerators. Atom RPG, I haven't played yet. I'm looking at it, though. They keep trying to give me a mop. Wait, does the mop really do... The mop does more damage than my nightstick does. Interesting. Didn't you follow the key? New follower is broken, I think. It's been a while. I played it when I was at work. Because sometimes my job requires me to disappear for a couple months at a time. So I'll let people know on Twitter and all that, but I will just vanish occasionally. I'm not dead. I'm not quitting. I just, my job requires me to disappear sometimes with no internet access. So when I was doing one of those jobs, though, I had the game downloaded to my laptop and I played the shit out of Undertale for like 5 months. Case with papers. Inactive spherical relic. Yes. Report on stolen relics. Official form neatly filed in firm hand. Judging by the stamps and signatures, it's been certified by a top Blackwing official. I'm not Spec Ops. No, no. I am an electrician in real life. And I work on radars, radios, and crypto technology. Tall blonde man in his 40s mechanically touches the brim of his black cap. This extends his hand, then extends his hand for a shake. His fingers are rock hard. He withdraws his hands as soon as he touches it. What the hell? The badge on his broad chest reads, Adolf Schmitz, head of security. Schmitz is studying you back, disapprovingly it seems. Alright, so every black team member that we've met so far has been a dick. And this guy, off the bat, won't let me touch him. He an electrician for the CIA black sites. Not like this. That'd be way cooler. I'd probably get paid a lot more, too. He wipes a bit of lint off your shoulder and adjusts the collar of your jumpsuit. Your uniform could use a wash. Badly. I'm Adolf Schmitz, head of security service. You were sent to Magellan, but there was a change of circumstances. The black nods towards the door behind him. I've got an urgent order for you. Your help is needed in a nearby object. Mr. Kingsley is waiting right now to give you your assignment. He'll tell you everything himself. It's really useful in the world. Goes post-apocalypse. I don't really imagine I'll be working on a lot of radars when the apocalypse happens, but it definitely helps that I had a side job a couple of years ago where I was fixing people's consoles, so they'd give me their console. I'd take it apart, run it through some tests, see what's wrong with it. Most of the time, I shit you not, it's just dirty, and so the contacts were kind of jacked up. So you'd get some rubbing alcohol, clean them up, put them back together, hand it off to that person, and it was good again. I had a buddy of mine from California fly out to me, because he had to come out to my area to work at the time. And he's like, hey, I got this Game Boy Color. If you fix it, it's yours. If not, you can just toss it. I was like, all right, cool. So now I have an original Game Boy Color that I fixed because it was just dirty contacts. Mr. Kingsley is waiting for you right next to give you your assignment. He'll tell you everything himself. Agree and proceed, blueing. Ask why he needs you, but not the other blue that arrived with you. Schmitz takes a small notebook from his pocket and quickly thumbs through it. One moment. It's all in here. Right. Your colleague's name is Igor Patanin? It seems here he doesn't speak English. Furthermore, his specialization is architecture. I doubt the problem at Nashville has anything to do with architecture. You know, that's super cool. I have some business to attend to. Otherwise, I'm just gonna go now. Bye.
Have a good one.
Hey, you know what this is about?
Hello.
Very creative dye job brings her spontaneous good cheer down on you like a sledgehammer. Say it. What did we say over here? What did we say, Woozle? Janitor bro, stay away from crazy. We don't know if she's crazy yet. Hi, how you doing, ma'am? I'm Yuki. I'm the most awesomest techie here. Leave. Leave. How do I leave? Act impressed. She smiles widely, twirling a lock of hair around her finger, then addresses you in a conspiratorial whisper. You know, they transferred me closer to the administration and science lab, even though I'm a blue and supposed to work on the mechanical floor. Bro, she's got five dimes. Looking like Rainbow Dash over here. So just because she's already pissed off everyone on the mechanical floor, it could be that you're... loud personality doesn't mesh with your coworkers. Yuki bites her lower lip, resentment playing in her eyes. She snorts loudly and turns away.
I hope to see you again soon.
Yeah. Fucking psycho people in this dome. I guess if you have a normal life, you're not really coming out to this area. Is he gonna let me leave? I have how many hours left? What is it, L? Yep, it is countdown. It is counting down. Oh shit. 22 hours and 34 minutes. Okay, we'll see what this guy needs for me real quick. Adolf. What do you need, Adolf?
So, where were we?
Go to the guard room. The video phone is on the wall over there. Okay. Alt. Armored door. Hog? Oh, it's a vehicle. Video phone. We're gonna close this door. Can I jam it? No. Okay. Bro, she's got five dies.
The giant display glows welcomingly when you approach. A red light comes on under the screen's steel hood. The camera is switched on.
If that's the dude, he looks like evil Colonel Sanders.
A gray old man with high cheekbones appears and squints out at you from the screen.
Do you copy?
That is evil Colonel Sanders.
He leans close to the camera, his glasses glittering.
My name is Martin Kingsley. I'm chief officer of Magellan Base. We were supposed to meet in person.
Have a good one, Woozle. Thank you for stopping by.
One moment. I'll grab your
phone. I'll have fun with the Psychofield Thunderdome. My name is Martin Kingsley, I'm chief manager. We're supposed to meet in person, but unfortunately, I'll grab your file. Oh, I don't like that I have a full file on me.
He reaches for something out of view and produces a thin folder with your name on the cover. Apparently, your file. Kingsley opens the folder to thumb through the pages. He marks one of the pages with a pencil.
Well, well. So you're in Blue Wing. A solid choice. Does it run in the family? Or did the role attract you for some other reason?
Guess right. He carries a family tradition. You like tinkering with machines. Enter the dome to advance the arms industry. Well, you see, sir, I'm just a big fan of working with machines and such.
The quick strokes of the administrator's pencils suggest he's added... two big plus signs to your file.
There's around 6,000 vehicles inside the dome now, and that number will only keep growing. You have enough work here for years to come.
Wait. Wait, that voice. For anyone that's played Metal Gear Solid, I think that's the Colonel's voice. You will continue playing until you beat this game or do a couple more streams before... I'm currently setting up a backlog, seeing which games my computer can handle streaming, which games I have fun streaming, and from those I'm going to decide currently I'm enjoying this game, so I'm probably going to put this on the rotation. Right now it's this, a game called Star Sector, and Pillars of Eternity. And I think I'm just going to rotate those three every so often and give them a couple hours, 3 to about 5 hours apiece every time I stream. So yeah, it's a rotation.
Kingsley closes the file and folds his hands in front of him.
Thank you for your reply. I learned a little more about you. Now I want you to learn a little bit more about us. Keep in mind, this is not a rehearsed speech.
By the way, Digital, do you prefer to go by Digital, or is it Key or Kai?
He assumes a serious expression.
When the dome was discovered in 1971, it became a scientific and media sensation, a worldwide phenomenon, and likely the most significant discovery in the history of mankind.
Yeah, this is the kernel for Metal Gear Solid.
Kingsley drums his fingers on the unseen desk, his gaze focused somewhere beyond.
I see. You were enticed here by radio advertising, telefilms, and all those interviews, billboards.
Gotcha. Thank you for the info.
Cronus wants the world to see the dome as a stage where something merry and fascinating is going on. But now that you're actually here, I want you to see the real picture.
Well, Mr. Kingsley, what I've discovered so far is that this is the Thunderdome. I played Deadfire on console, and I only got to like level 6. So now that I'm streaming, it'll give me more emphasis reasons to play it. And I found out that I can carry the Pillar of Exile games 1 save and decisions over to Deadfire. So I've built a paladin in 1. I'm going to try to run him all the way through and bring him into Deadfire. Tyranny is also on my list. I'm going to try to complete a game before I pick that one up, but it's definitely on my list. I'm trying to focus on games that I can do that are either inherently roleplay or are open to being roleplayed in. I like doing dumb little voices and making up stories for the events happening in the game. Well, Mr. Kingsley, I see that this is the Thunderdome and people are insane here.
You can't make out his eyes behind the glare on his spectacles, but he seems to be staring directly at you.
Here's the truth. Nobody was waiting for us inside the dome. It's neither a treasury of technologies nor a cemetery of the ancients. Perhaps what we're doing now is defusing the world's most complicated bomb. Will our mission thrive? I believe so. If we work together and everybody does their part.
So before I started streaming, I actually started a Pathfinder game, and I kind of like it. It doesn't give me the same vibe of actually playing Pathfinder, which was the first tabletop game I got into. And the bard isn't as overpowered as I was able to make it in the real game. But it's also on my list eventually. Like, I'm gonna... Like, I have this list of RPGs that I want to burn through. And whenever I have free time, whenever I'm not at work and I have internet access, I have my computer and all that, I want to, like, power through. Not power through, because it sounds like I'm trying to, like, do it as fast as possible. I want to enjoy my time, but actually make my way through these different games. I believe so. If we work together and everything does their part. Well, sure, I got no problem working together with people.
He looks back at your file.
I say, do what must be done. Because that's what the concept of the five wings is all about.
Neverwinter Nights. No, I have played Baldur's Gate and Planescape. I haven't played Neverwinter Nights yet, though.
Kingsley points at the camera.
You're from Blue Wing. You're looking at the world's most
complicated
infrastructure, and that complexity keeps growing.
Is Neverwinter the MMO one?
Your duties are not limited to maintenance and service. You'll be keeping up the image of the world in its accustomed form. Without hot water and electricity, people will revert to beasts in an astonishingly short order, though it might seem that.
I have played the, no, it's not that one. Okay, yeah, not, if it's the one that's like Planescape and Baldur's Gate and, what's the ice one? Icewind Dale. And I've played The BioWare one. No, I don't think I have. Neverwinter Nights by BioWare? That's probably before KOTOR, I think. Neverwinter Nights. BioWare. Oh, shit. Did BioWare start off on D&D games? Look at that. I'm gonna have to check that out now. Thank you for informing me of that.
Putting the folder aside, he sits back and stares at you in silence. It gets so quiet that the ticking of a clock can be heard through the speakers.
Database. Oh, don't. Nobody click on that link. That's an IP grabber. Nobody click on that guy's name. Don't check out his channel at all. Every time you see Haas00312 or some variation of that, that's an IP grabber. Don't click on. Hey, there's another one. Yeah, just don't click on any of those.
Kingsley sighs quietly.
You were probably waiting for some boilerplate welcome speech. But I prefer to talk about real world problems. Glad to meet you.
Hell yeah. Hey, followers are followers, man. I prefer to talk about real world problems. Glad to meet you. Well, sure, it's nice to meet you as well.
Martin nods slowly.
I apologize once again for this long distance meeting. Now, as we don't have much time, I'd like to get to the point.
I'm a big fan of Obsidian games.
I'm sure you're curious why you were taking off the bus to Magellan and brought here instead.
There's a game that I always attribute to Obsidian, but I don't think it was actually made by Obsidian. It was a OG Xbox game, and you played as giant blue people who had control of the elements. If I could find that game again, I can't remember the name of it. I remember I had a good time with it, though. If I can find that game, I'd play that on stream, and that'd be a weird blast of the past game. Something like Azeric Defender Parathia, I think.
He moves closer to the camera.
I'm going to show you a short video. Please pay attention.
All right, sir. I'm always down to watch a video or two.
Kingsley's face freezes on screen.
I have an urgent mission for an employee of your background and qualifications. I'd have assigned someone from Magellan, but I'm short on personnel. That's why it has to be a newcomer. I apologize again for the rush, but it seems I have no choice.
That is so cyberpunk evil, Colonel Sanders. I'm gonna repeat that because that's just all I'm seeing.
Martin noisily clears his throat.
Maybe you've heard about Nashville Base. While preparing the materials for this mission, I came across a short documentary film about the complex. I think you should watch it.
All right, sure, I'll keep on watching.
The speakers produce a hollow click. Purple, gray, and black spots flicker on the screen. A blurred title, The Cronus Archive 1971 to 1974, was used in the production of this recording, appears at the bottom. The shadow of an airplane flies across a faded yellow desert. A cheery voice fills the room. Every day, our researchers uncover more and more of the dome's secrets. There is no doubt the underground structures, so-called objects, are organized according to some pattern. Though early on, the importance of the relics to scientific research was considered insignificant.
Yeah, so what I'm gathering is that a dome just appeared in the desert. It wasn't found, it just kind of popped up somewhere.
The desert dims into the black of a chalkboard. White lines drawn by an invisible hand begin to sketch a schematic of the dome.
All right, I see an S pattern, but I don't see any other pattern.
The narrator continues. By 1972, however, many important discoveries had come to light in a period of only a few months, and the construction of stationary research bases adjacent to the more promising objects began. Personnel moved into Ankara in May of 1972, And within half a year, Boston and Dessau were also brought into service, though the biggest discovery was yet to come.
Did they find an ancient alien body? Perhaps, or a portal?
The picture changes to a chasm suffused with electric light. People bustling about everywhere.
Yeah, so another thing that I think adds to the 70s aesthetic is that everything has that, like, Austin Powers villain look to it, where it's not quite skin-tight suits, but they're pretty tight outfits that are very flamboyant in color when the color exists.
The speaker's voice seems to come from a distance. In November of 1973, a massive network of underground caves and a structure of hitherto unseen complexity was discovered in Sector C-12. Soon afterwards, the construction of C-12 Nashville began.
Okay, so Nashville's not the name of a base. I guess it is a base, but it's an underground cave area. Okay.
The camera glides through dim caverns as the silhouettes of bizarre mechanisms emerge. Metal structures loom up from the dark, surrounded by earth-moving machines and exhausted miners wearing orange jumpsuits. The speaker continues. C-12 Nashville is an innovative research complex located atop the primary relic mining location. The complexity of this object is unique. Communications.
Okay.
The film abruptly cuts out, and Kingsley's face reappears.
The rest of this information is classified. Hopefully you get the main idea. Nashville is a very special place, requiring people with both special qualifications and special clearance level, though yours will do for your task.
Well, sir, perhaps I can know if I have any friends helping me with this situation. I'm just a lone engineer.
Kingsley lowers his eyes and flips through some documents.
Only the driver. The rest of the group has already departed. I'll tell you everything you need to know. Don't worry.
Well, what are you naming it to do, sir?
Martin adjusts his glasses.
So, the task. Nashville Base stopped transmitting and receiving signals yesterday evening. A reconnaissance group was sent out earlier today, but we haven't heard anything from them yet either.
I'll just continue on then.
The chief officer rubs his forehead.
Normally, I would never give this task to a newcomer like yourself, but I just don't have enough people.
Well, I might be a newcomer, sir, but I'll let you know I'm highly qualified for the job.
He looks down at the documents again.
Furthermore, the group was lacking someone with your specialization. The communication problem appears to be more severe than I thought. Nashville's technicians could use another Blue Winger's help.
Well, is what I'm here for, sir.
Kingsley is looking into the camera once more.
Your task is to get to Nashville, figure out whatever's behind the communication problem, get in touch with the group, and work with them to solve the problem.
Okay.
The chief officer carefully returns the documents to the folder. You notice his hands tremble slightly.
Go downstairs. The truck must be waiting for you in storage. This task is urgent, but a small delay is acceptable if there's anything you need to settle here first. That is all. Any questions?
No questions, sir. This seems very black ops and mysterious, and I feel if I ask too many questions, I'll end up with two bullet holes in the back of my head, so no questions.
Kingsley's hand reaches toward the camera.
Great to hear. Take care of yourself. I'll talk to you later.
Well, that wasn't damn terrifying. Prepare yourself to leave the base's defensive perimeter and venture into the outside world of the dome, when you must rely solely on yourself and your companions. Check your gear one last time and go to the orange truck waiting for you in the garage. You'll be able to acquire your own vehicles, which will act as your mobile base of operations and give you unprecedented freedom and movement. Good to know. Hey, Adolf.
Oh, you again.
Gotcha. So I just got out there into the truck. All right.
It was nice chatting.
I'm gonna leave you.
Don't touch that door.
Okay, calm your tits. Let's go to L. Okay, so done with that. Series of strange events. All right, that's my current mission. What have I learned? Relic. First class relic, presumably function liquid container, liquid cooler, liquid producer. Radiates a stable electromagnetic field section with unidentified liquid inside. Cannon shell? Bimetallic core detachable casing. Cooler. Yeah, this is very roadside picnic-esque. That's what Woozle was saying. RLWZ. He was mentioning that, like, this comes across as a stalker-esque, where I'm in this zone where nobody is supposed to go to, and I'm finding these weird objects that in the setting of Roadside Picnic are literally just the trash that aliens left on our planet, but we think, oh my god, it's a super weapon. The visible spectrum. Military consumable, instrument consumable cutlery, it's weak ionizing radiation. Okay. Garment, occult object, radiates stable. I wish I could have like a little picture of what we're talking about here. Anomalies, yep. First level, like, just super weird. Oh wait, is there anything I can steal in here before I get out? Locker, TV set, turnstile doors, janitor gear, trash bin, TV set, empty, empty, empty. All right, let's go over here. I don't have much in the way of weaponry. I have a broom. That's my weapon. Oh joy. That the vehicle? Ooh, boxes. Let's search the boxes. Reagent, state of plastic container with a reagent kit. Delivered to us all scientific centers under the dome. It has potential uses, not all of them legal. Sure, why not? Take. Check out that box. Is anyone looking? Can I just break it? Nah, my character wouldn't break into it. Open boxes? Sure, it's for anybody. Electronic equipment. Polymetallic ore. Let's make a shiv out of that. Okay, over here.
Those are the rules, Todd. Nothing I can do about it. Sorry.
Box. What the fuck is that thing? Am I fighting on Clendathu? Is this Starship Troopers now? The only good bug is a dead bug. Who do I talk to? Good, good. Radio contact with Nashville was recently lost. You've been instructed to get in touch with the group before Magellan. C-12 Nashville facility at once. Talk Todd, talk Ulf. Use MM truck. Where am I supposed to go again? Ooh, someone's personal lockers. Why not find out what information I can? Yes. Mm-hmm. Gunbrush. Don't really plan on using guns, but can't hurt. What is up with this giant dead bug, though? There's a huge, disgusting dead insect lying on the cargo trailer. It most closely resembles an ordinary cockroach. Yellow hemolymph flows among the tarpaulin's folds and mixes with the acid, leaving bleach stains on the cloth. Scan the cockroach with your scanner. Soldier merchant behind Drake in his black dusty uniform. Are you from the technical department? Sophie wants to know when her servo shell will be ready. Did the parts arrive yet? Yeah, you just arrived at the dome. Ah, I see. Then I'll tell you what to expect. endless crawling through ventilation ducts, repairing air conditioners, as well as mainframes, kettles, and coffee machines. Most of your time will be wasted on ordering parts for the bureaucrats, and then you'll be working into the night to avoid fines from the Silvers. To make it short, you're gonna bust your ass for no thanks. I know. My sister works in the service center. Well, thanks for the heads up, I guess. Well, time to make my way this way. I want to drive that car. An unremarkable Jupiter moon covered with a thin layer of desert dust is parked in repair bay. Look in the window. Upholstered in grayish blue, empty soda cans perch in slightly scuffed seats. We're gonna move away from that, actually. I think this is what I'm supposed to be taking. This fucking hog of a beast. Look at this thing. Eagle's number has been scrubbed off by the desert. Must be the transport Kingsley spoke of. Continue. The driver's side door is half open. A young woman is sitting sideways in the driver's seat, legs hanging out.
Oh, hello there.
She offers her hand. Hi, I'm Clara Morgan. And you're the novice going to Nashville, right? What's your name? How do you feel? You mind if I smoke in the car? Her handshake is surprisingly firm. Clara smells of soap, some fragrance, and slightly of gasoline. Well, nice to meet you, kind lady. I'm Tobias. Tobias McGuffee. Glad to meet you, too. How did you like the load capsule? The funicular. I've got nuts. You want some? Or candy? I've got chocolate-covered fruit. Try some. Did you know candied fruit are dried? They're boiled in syrup. You climb into the cabin and plunk yourself in the passenger seat. The truck seems bigger on the inside. A wooden rosary is hanging from the driver's head mirror. The radio murmurs quietly. Lean back in my chair. Clara slams the door. Are we going then? Should probably go now. The roads are bad. Very little asphalt. Dirt tracks mostly. God willing, we'll get there before that storm hits. Mind if I turn the radio up a bit? Do you like music? Blues? Gospel? For instance, I like. You can't make out exactly what Clara likes. The roar of the engine smothers the rest of her sentence and the truck lurches into motion. Well, that got loud real fast. Oh, we're right up next to the roadside picnic staging post. Yep. They took a lot of inspiration from Stalker. Hey, what's up, IP Grabber? Doing me a favor, thank you.
The highway leading to C-12 Nashville is blocked by an anomalous storm, and you're forced to detour over a mountain pass.
Hey, look at all these followers I'm getting, man. Good day. Don't click on any of those names, like I said before. Just don't touch any of those names. A highway leading to C-12 Nashville is blocked by an anomalous storm, and you're forced to detour over a mountain pass. Soon, the radiator boils over, and you have to stop.
Clara lifts up the hood and thoroughly examines the steaming radiator.
The engine's boiling, so we'll have to wait. You do know what happens when a car boils, right? It's...
The blue shuts her mouth abruptly and stares anxiously at the dark funnel cloud dancing on the horizon. Now that you're on higher ground, it's clear that the storm has overtaken a fairly large section of road. It will be difficult to pass.
Well... Yeah, you've been here for a while. What do you propose we do?
The blue looks at the engine again.
We wait. As soon as it cools down, we'll go. This storm worries me more, but it's not an insurmountable problem. I heard there are some relics at the local gas station that protect against anomalies. You could even accidentally step on one out here, they say. Mysterious are the ways of the Lord.
Ask her about anomaly storms like this one. Find out what's injured at the gas station. What are you saying? What do you know about this gas station?
Morgan thinks for a moment.
It's a combination cafe gas station called Roadside Picnic. Never been there myself, but there's something off about it. There are several anomalies around there and weird relics, Supposedly, machines and structures decay much faster than they should in that area. But maybe that's just a story.
Ask her to tell you more about the relics, ask about the knowledge rooms like this. Hey, Claire, what happened do you know about these storms, the green lightning?
The blue looks at the storm once more.
There have been more and more of these lately, and they're getting stronger. I personally think it's divine judgment for how we've squandered the riches under the dome.
Why is everyone under this dome crazy?
She sighs and squirms.
I knew people who got caught in one of those storms. They blow up so fast, there's no chance to get away. God rest their souls.
The blue makes the sign of the cross.
And this gas station you said has relics. What do these relics consist of?
Your companion perks up a bit. She seems to be interested in this subject.
This place is registered as a resource anomaly zone. Do you know what that is? It's when the relics mined there have been studied and deemed useful.
Oh, okay, that didn't really give me a lot of information, Clara. Not much is known about these relics. They dampen anomaly fields, even very strong ones. They're also found in other parts of the dome. They're known as bronze apples or aluminum apples. I don't remember what, but there's something like that. Leave, saying that you're going to go to the gas station and figure everything out. Ooh, I'm finally in the wild. Me and my mop. Let's go off the path immediately. A rust-eaten radioactive hazard sign. Stealth. Oh, shit. Nope. Okay, we're going to go into the inventory. One of these is radiation resistance. I think radiation is energy. Yeah. Consume AA rad. Let's fucking go. Rad force. Perfect. Collapsed building of some kind. We got enemy targets? What is that? Oh shit, those are anomalies. Okay. Newton. And there's an enemy. Junk rat. Fuel barrel. Let's wait before I get some better gear. Okay, let's off to this side. Tab. Oh, it's the gas station. Just around the corner. Okay. And there's something in the gas station. Well, time to get ready for the day and have to go. Do you stream in the evening times or mostly the day? I am usually aiming around noon, or I stream way later at like 9 p.m. EST. It's a bit of a mad scramble, honestly. But I usually tweet it out first, or I'll send a message here to let people know before I stream by about an hour or two. Thanks for asking. Trap, 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 trap. We are going to melee kill our way through. Thank you again for stopping by, and I hope you have a great day. Still tweaking out. Just get some help. You'll need that. Maybe these aren't enemies. Forefather stuff.
Why do you even care?
This way. Examine decommissioned turret. Trucks. Tower. big ass building. Let's just enter this place. I'm sure nothing could go wrong.
Who the hell goes there? Come on in.
Hello, sir.
Already here.
A weird, scruffy old man with a matted beard is sitting in front of the checkout terminal. The badge on his blue jumpsuit is long since bleached away. The name Aaron Melville is written there in black marker.
Just use marker. Works for me.
With a groan, he picks up a magnifying glass and, peering through it, begins poking at the keyboard with one knobby finger.
The computer plays a short tune. Checkmate, the system declares.
The old man angrily sets the magnifying glass aside.
A grandmaster? You're a piece of junk, not a grandmaster. And a cheater to boot.
He raises his head to squint in your direction.
Hey, what do you want? I don't advise eating here, and there's nothing to buy. And either way, we're closed.
The shopkeeper rises from his seat, and you notice he's sporting a peg where his left leg should be.
Well, sorry to impose, sir, but our truck recently broke down.
The old man throws up his hands with a scowl.
Then go fix it.
People say that the roadside picnic here is immune to the anomalies. You have any way of protecting the truck from that?
Melville reluctantly points a crooked finger at the front door.
Go out there and walk over to the gas station. Go down to the basement. There's an anomaly, a tree. It's glowing. And there are some golden thingies hanging off it. We make special devices from that fruit called anomaly protectors. Should one be laying around on the floor, go grab it, then put it in the truck and bug off to... Where was it you was going to? That's where you bug off to.
The blue starts slapping the pockets on his overalls. After a little digging, he pulls out a little key on a shoelace.
Only take the device, you hear? It's company property. I should be charging you myself, as a matter of fact.
Well, sure, you don't need to be a dick about it. Swallow and Rabindranath Krishna Swami. What the fuck is that name? What culture is that name? Rabindranath Krishna Swami. I don't have a clue. As you approach the table, you catch the end of a strange dialogue. A gray, long-haired man in a silver jacket is making weird gestures as he confidently explains something to the young girl sitting next to him. The only logical and undoubtedly correct answer to this all is the dome vibrates out of sync with the universe. Hence all of the anomalies, man. Seeing you, he raises two fingers in a peace sign. The man radiates good and calm will. Peace be upon you, brother. My name is Rabindranath Krishnaswami, and this is my sister, Swallow. With her outsized pupils, Sister Swallow's eyes remind you of twin forefather anomalies. She stretches herself out on top of the table as if hoping to melt into it. Oh, hello. My fingers are so warm. Lines. Lines. Waves? Rabindranath looks from her to you and giggles like a child. I'm sorry, man. When I feel good, I like to share with my neighbors. Ignore it, please. Look more closely at the twosome. Swallow rubs her cheeks against the table surface, absolute peace written all over her face. Rabindranath sways slightly on the couch and weaves in an invisible pattern in the air with his fingers. These two have taken enough drugs to knock out the entire Blackwing squadron. Damn. Having guessed what you're thinking, the silver gives you a tricksy smile. Well, consciousness doesn't widen itself. You have to help it along. It's very good for deep spiritual discussions, you know? First boom, 60, the second wave. Okay. Everyone needed drugs to increase strength, deftness, and quick wits. Knowledge of the forefathers made it possible to compose new breakthrough recipes that have... Okay. Violation of authorities. Calm them down. It's okay. They can widen their consciousness as much as they want. Hit that you wouldn't mind a little consciousness. I'm not a drug user, but you do you. Well, sure. Hope you enjoy widening your conscience. I'm gonna go do what I need to do. Have a great time. Ravager Nath laughs. Well, that's a very wise attitude to take, isn't it, Swallow? The girl nods enthusiastically. Krishnaswami slaps himself on the forehead. What a crazy pants I am. I'm sorry I brought Jotha Jones with me. Have you heard about him? Oh, I'll read some of my favorite quotes around. Join our book club if you wish. Club,
Why should we depend on rational knowledge? Reason leads us up a blind alley.
Oh, that is not the voice I expected from that guy.
There are only two true paths to knowledge. Mystical epiphanies and my
book. Okay, so I have to find the basement. You said it was across the road? It's in the garage? Okay, let's walk over here and check out the garage. Medical kits. Stack of documents. Don't care about those. A shovel? Yes. Electronic equipment? Yes. Springs, yes. Duct tape, can't go wrong with that. Alright. Toolbox. What do we have here? A hammer. You know what? I like the hammer more because it's a tighter spread. Like, yes, the mop can get 12 to 27, which is a 15-point difference. This one could go 17 to 21. That's only 4-point difference, so it's a higher chance of getting the big number. So we're going to take that. We're going to drop the mop. All right. Close that. Go to my equipment. And then we're just going to drop this off to the side. Drop. Strip it? Oh. And the Knights Club really just sucks at what it's supposed to do, so... 15, 16, crit mod, yep, strip, spare parts, can I, there we go, auto select that, works for me, cardboard boxes, more over here, what do we got, we are looking at nothing found, oh, it's the combined boxes, alright, craft something. 40mm grenade. I can just make grenades. Dope. Canisters. I just got a pop-up. What'd that pop? Oh, I leveled up. Let's go. Okay. Skill points. And ability points. Options. Tinkerer. Light weapons. I should probably have a couple points in a gun-related skill. Just to... let's see. Probably shotguns. Go with that. Where's my applied at? Tech. Survival. Influence. Let's get that to a decent level. There we go. Over here, where is my tab? Let's see what my mission currently is. I was almost close to the gas station, is out of order due to the anomaly zone. However, there is a way out. Aaron says that sometimes you can find relics at the gas station, created especially. One of them is in the basement of the gas station. Where, how do I get to the basement? Basement door around here, I can see. Maybe it's inside?
I understand so much now.
Okie dokie. Use the door. Where's the basement at? Yeah, man, where's the basement at?
The old man sits at the counter with his head propped in one hand.
No food, no supplies, and the coffee is portioned.
Nope, he's not gonna give me more information. Alright, so let's walk over here. This is the other gas station. Okay, so maybe it's over here. What do you got to pass on to me, buddy?
Come on, don't be shy.
A man in a dirty blue jumpsuit is sitting on a bench by the gas station. He's lifted up a cotton pad and balancing a piece of rock on his knee. I like his helmet. The blue moistens the cotton pad with alcohol and runs it over the stone. Then he squeezes the essence into a metal jar. The jar emits a golden light. The cotton pad freezes mid-wipe. The blue looks up. You read his badge. Travis Brighton. Explosive Ordnance Disposal. Fuck yes. Are you going inside the gas station? I wouldn't recommend it. The blue squeezes the pad and sets it aside. You can see he's a little nervous. What's wrong with the gas station? It's like this. There are all kinds of anomalies. Hey man, thanks for the other IP grabber, man. It's like this. There are all kinds of anomalies. Some of them are just horrible. You get me? There is a lot of such places, and awful things happen to anyone who stumbles across them. I'm gonna look big tomorrow. The gas station itself isn't that bad, but the basement. There's something here, man. Something like a tree, and it's running out of room. It's gonna be too big for the space, mark my words. Sometimes it sheds these smaller relics. They're nothing special, but they do protect you from all kinds of anomalies, which is useful. I found one myself, but the effect's already worn off, and I'm not going back to look for another. He gestures you to lean in. There's someone in the basement, a very skeezy someone. Not alive, but they're also not dead. In one word, a nasty thing. I don't recommend meeting it. Radom scans you closely. That's not a rhetorical question now, is it? I'm sitting outside a weird gas station with a basement still straight out of Weird Tales, mining relic dust. Ask if it's legal. Technically, no. Well, Kronos encourages the black market for relics every way they can, so... Anything around here? Full of interesting stuff. It's an anomalous zone, after all. Machinery doesn't last long in this area, so I walked here. The whites say it's a typical ritual-grade anomaly. And even I know where the source is. The blues turn to look meaningfully at this gas station behind him. It's all from the gas station. There's a huge second-class fractal relic in the basement. And sometimes small golden balls fall off of it. I would take a couple for myself, but well, there's something weird going on in there. I advise you to stay away. Ask why it's worthless. A man working in a swamp told me whenever you find microflux, you find the Mobius. Well, whatever the Mobius are, you'd better not go. I'm glad the passage to the swamp has been blocked up by rocks. Feels safer. What's happening in the basement? Can you just tell me? Brighton waves you off. All right, as long as you leave me out of it. Two words. Something living. There's something alive in there, and it's barely resembles a human being. There's enough for me to keep my distance. So you'd like to discuss something else? I'm going to leave.
Back again.
And I'm going to save. Trash bin. And I'll take all. We're gonna have the hammer out. Nope, didn't mean to actually sit. Okay, open that up, nothing there. Open the barrel. Packaged water? Yes. Onion? Yes. Actually, yeah, I forgot this game has a hunger system. I'm not hungry, I'm not thirsty. We're good, so far. Supply barrel. Alright. Military grade medical kit. What the hell is that? Sterile bandages. Take all. Canisters. Canister. Two of those. Alright, actually, everybody, I'm going to go have some lunch, or I guess dinner at this point. And I'll be back later. So have a great time. I'll send a tweet out when I plan to come back. And yeah, see you all later.